हम लोग शुरू कर सकते हैं चाहें।
इनका क्या नाम है, इनका सोफी साहब का भेजा है क्या? हेलो, am I audible?
हाँ जी, हाँ जी, वी कैन हियर यू मुंशी जी। तपन जी प्रणाम।
नमस्कार सर।
We are looking forward to learning a little more about how far this mercury is used in Unani system C. So Munshiji, it's a very exciting event today.
Surely.
मैं आशा करता हूं कि डॉक्टर यूनुस मुंशी जी 5-6 बजे, आदरणीय मुंशी जी को नमस्कार है।
नमस्कार सर,
डॉक्टर वहीद साहब पर छोड़ने का इंतजार कर रहे हैं। डॉक्टर वहीद साहब जुड़ जाएंगे वैसे ही हम लोग कार्यक्रम की शुरुआत करेंगे।
मुझे सर उनका
आज
भी
का दिन
था
हमारा
जो
यूनानी के ऊपर डिस्कस करने का है। यूनानी के सभी एक्सपर्ट्स हमारे साथ हैं, मेरा बड़ा सौभाग्य है। डॉक्टर परीक्षित मेरी ओर से होस्ट कर रहे हैं, डॉक्टर जयेश ठक्कर मेरी ओर से को होस्ट हैं, और मेरे गार्जियन डॉक्टर मदन थंगवेलू जी सामने बैठे हुए हैं। तो मुझे किस बात की चिंता है, मैं रास्ते में हूँ, जैसे ही मैं लैपटॉप तक पहुंचता हूँ वैसे ही मैं लैपटॉप से ज्वाइन हो जाऊंगा।
परीक्षित जी नमस्कार।
प्रणाम सर, प्रणाम टू
आवर
डिस्टिंग्विश्ड
सर,
एक्सपर्ट्स प्रेजेंट हियर।
मुंशी जी, डॉक्टर यूनिस मुंशी जी,
जी 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 सर, हेलो।
मैं वहीद साहब को फोन कर रहा हूं, जैसे ही वहीद साहब जॉन होते हैं हम लोग इस कार्यक्रम की तुरंत शुरुआत कर देंगे। मैं नहीं जानता कहां टेक्निकल ग्लिच हुआ है।
सोफी साहब का चाहिए था सीवी। जी सर, जी हेलो, जी जी नमस्कार नमस्कार। ठीक है मैं कर लेता हूँ, लेकिन अभी हाँ हाँ मैं देख लेता हूँ कौन कौन आ रहे हैं, मैं देख लू। जी 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 हेलो,
नमस्ते एवरीबॉडी। टुडे आई विल स्टार्ट द प्रोसीडिंग्स। टुडे आवर main speakers will be Dr. Muhammad Abdul Wahid, Dr. Abdul Wadud, also Dr. Muhammad Idris, Dr. Ghulamuddin Sofi, Dr. Qazi Zaid Ahmed, Dr. Hamiduddin, and Dr. Shahid Chaudhary. And today's moderator will be Dr. Yunis Munshi ji sir, and Professor K.R.C. Reddy sir will be co-hosting the today's webinar. I welcome you all, sir. And today is the day before World Ayurveda Day, and today we are celebrating, or we'll be discussing mainly on the necessity of mercury in use of Ayush system. And this webinar series has been started 2 days ago. So today we'll be discussing on the power of the mercury efficacy and essentials in Unani aspect. I welcome you also, and we are very glad that you could join our webinar today. And we'll start our proceedings very shortly.
We are waiting basically for Dr. M. Wahid Saab to join us, because he has to inaugurate the webinar. But as I see, Dr. Chaudhary has already joined, and I think we have with us other members also.
Idris sir is joining. Idris sir will join within 10 or 5 minutes. Idris sir is in marriage ceremony. He will join. So we can start the program with the speaker who is available.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Sir, should we start the program with the Dhanvantari Stuti?
Parikshit, start live.
Yes, sir. Yeah, already started, sir. So, should I run the Dhanvantari Vandana? Pawan, sir, are you there?
I think you go ahead.
Okay, sir. Sir, with your kind permission, I am starting the Dhanvantari Vandanas and Stuti.
Yeah, yeah. You start that. Until then, the call will join.
Okay, sir.
Properly.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
विघ्नेश्वराय वरदाय सुरः प्रियाय लंबोदराय सकलाय जगद्धिताय नागाननाय श्रुतियज्ञ विभूषिताय गौरीसुताय गणनाथ नमो नमस्ते कर्पूर गौरम करुणावतारम संसार सारम भुजगेन्द्रहारम सदा वसंतम हृदयारविंदे भवम भवानी सहितहार धवला या शुभ्रवस्त्राव्रता या वीणा वरदंडमप्रभृतिभिः देवैः सदा वंदिता सामां पातु सरस्वती भगवती निःशेषजाड्यापहा सर्वमंगलमांगल्ये शिवे सर्वार्थसाधिके शरण्ये त्र्यंबके गौरी नारायणी नमोस्तुते आविर्बभूव कलशं दधदर्ण वाद्यः पीयूषपूर्ण मम रत्वक्रते सुराणाम् रोगजालजीर्ण जनता जनितः प्रसंसो धन्वंतरित भगवान् भविकाय भूयात् श्री धन्वंतरय नमः ओम शांति ओम शांति ओम शांति
वेलकम यू आल्सो it is a very we are very glad that we are starting this
ये वही साहब है ना जॉइन इट यट ना
I would like to welcome you all on 238 webinar today. Thank you for joining us. Today's moderator is respected Dr. Yunus Munshi ji, head Regional Research Institute Unani. So I would like to welcome you all on behalf of Independent Research Society, Vishwa Ayurved Parishad and Imami Jhandu. Welcome you all, sir. Welcome Kaji Saheb. Welcome Shahid ji. Welcome Yunus Munshi ji. Swagatam sabhi ka. Main Yunus Munshi ji se agrah karunga ki aage ki sabha ka sanchalan Yunus Munshi ji shuruaat kare. Munshi ji namaskar.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. In the name of the Lord, Lord of the universe and Lord of all things who have created the all things, who created we people, in the name of him. Let me start it with one where we are sorry to convey to our participants that Professor Wadood Saab has some work, important work, and he has not been able to join us today. So I think Pavanji, Wahid Saab joined kiye hai kya? Hello? Wahid Saab join, I mean Wahid Saab join, hello?
Wahid Saab to abhi tak sir join nahi kiye.
So let us start it and let him join afterwards and he'll inaugurate at that time. Us time unko time de denge, but we'll start it. So I welcome Dr. Chaudhary from NIM, who is assistant professor there, Dr. Kazi, who are the main speakers in today's webinar. Then we have Professor Ghulamuddin Sofi Saab, who is heading the Department of Ilm al-Adwiya, and which has the major role to play in today's webinar, because this pertains to the pharmacology and pharmacognosis, even pharmaceutical practices. Although what I know, because I am not from the subject, I'm from different subject, but as a clinician, as a researcher, I know it that there is not so much use of mercury in Unani system of medicine. We use it in the form in combination with the sulfur and gandak ke saath kiya jata hai jab shangarf banaya jata hai, after purifying it and after getting it wo basm jab banate hain baaki cheeze. Although I don't have so much of knowledge, but I welcome all the people on the board. And we have, as usual, with us Dr. Madan from Birmingham. And he has been very much enthusiastic towards the Unani system of medicine. Yes. Although he has a lot of knowledge of his own system, that is Ayurveda. And he has always been supportive of this series of webinars. We have Professor V.K. Agnihotri ji. We welcome you, sir. We wish to learn a lot from your expertise also, and other dignitaries who are over here. I think I am still a student. I feel myself a student amongst you people, because there are all the people have been in the teaching community in one way or the other. So let us start with from Dr. Kazi Saab.
Yes, I am here. Thank you so much.
Dr. Kazi Zaid Saab is with us. We'll start with him. You can share the screen. You can start the presentation, sir. Please. Let me first introduce that why we are here, because as we are discussing this thing for the last couple of days, that government has, it is not only the World Health Organization, I think, so that they wish to go for the mercury free world. While as mercury is being used in the traditional system of medicines, let it be Ayurveda, let it be Unani, Siddha, all the Ayush systems. So we have to submit a proposal to the government that at least there should be licensed people who can sell mercury, who can provide mercury to the industrial class, or even to the institutions like NIM who are doing research day in and day out. And they need the mercury for their use in the laboratories, in the clinics. So this should be licensed, and how we can submit the proposal to the government, and how much it is needed in the Unani system today. We need to know that from the experts who are available over here. Okay, Qazi Saab, you can go ahead, please.
Assalamu alaikum and very good evening to all of you. I think it is a very important and step has taken from the organizer to save our traditional system. And here I have given the topic, what is the role of mercury in Yunani medicine? So I have accommodated and prepared some slides by which you can even understand how much importance has been given in Yunani system of medicine, the mercury. So 20 minutes is, I think, very too much short of the time. So I will only a flying overview on the topic. And by this slides, you can even understand what are the importance of the mercurial preparation and from which era it has begin it began and up to what level it has given importance in the Yunani system of medicine and what type of preparations available in the Yunani system of medicine and how many types they have used it. So now I am starting the slides by which you can understand the in a very lucid manner. So first, the topic is the role of mercury in Yunani medicine, what I have given to discuss about the topic. And the first one is, what is the importance in the society, in the rites, in the ritual, in the literature, in Yunani system of medicine? So while going through the literature, I have seen so many names, so many vernacular, so many synonyms. Even I have seen that 120 versions or pseudonyms are available for the mercury or for the mercury or the silver liquid or the king of all the liquid. So the name reflects the physicochemical characteristic of the mercury. For example, the volatile farar and fur, the volatile slave of the abiq, the heavy qatil, or the saqil, or the speedy serial harka. And I am audible to all of you now. Hello.
Sir, you are audible. Sir, you are presenting any slide?
Yeah, I'm presenting now.
Sir, please share it on your screen. Oh. We have made you the presenter.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Share.
Yes, sir. Yes, screen is visible, sir. Just make it big. Yes, sir, just make it full screen, it will be easy. Okay. So it's visible. Your slides are visible. Your screen is visible. Just make the slide full screen.
Okay. share. Are you Microsoft PowerPoint? Share them. The slide is now looking?
Yes, sir, it's visible. Just make it full screen, sir.
First one?
Full screen.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Wait, I'm sorry for the interruption. No. Is it seen now?
No, sir, it's not visible. Yes, sir, it's visible now. Yes, sir, it's visible. So, just sir, make it full screen.
First.
Just make it full screen, sir. Just please help, sir, how to...
Okay, I will.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That, yeah, keep that one, sir. Yes, sir.
I'm sorry for... So I have told you earlier that 120 version pseudonyms the volatile, which reflects the physicochemical characteristic of that. And now the sub theory such as the father of jaldi karna time ko main thoda sa ye kaha isko hatayenge aise ye hata ha bas theek thank and likewise it is related to the some theory that like father of minerals abul madin the female unsa and the white bride aruse bayaza and likewise the name has also represent the mystical alchemical concept such as the divine water my ilahi the phoenix unqa and the spirit of matter ruh al ajsad so I want to emphasize here that 120 pseudonyms found in the literature in the rites and ritual in the fiction and non-fiction likewise in the medical fraternity so you can understand or think about what the importance has been given to the mercury or simab or zibak or para so now I want to show the you know from the beginning that Yunani scholars has extensively dealt with the detail of the mercury either they have used it or not for example Dioscorides has mentioned about the sublimation method of extracting mercury from cinnabar likewise the Galen who has the corpus Galenium comprised several books on pharmacognosy including Kitab al-Adwiya al-Mufrada he has also mentioned about the mercury or para or with the name of zibak it is a matter of fact that the Dioscorides and Dioscorides which is known as Yunani and Galen and Paul of Aegina it is the time of 7th or 8th century did not use the mercury as remedy for humans but they have described about its characteristics they did not mention about the therapeutic uses but they have mentioned it in detail Paul of Aegina has mentioned somewhere in his book that derivative of mercury was used internally against colic and ileus and ileus are in the history so in the latter period Al-Tabri and Masar Jawai. They have introduced first time in the history the dust of mercury. Dust of mercury for skin diseases, and they have mentioned that therapeutic uses in yellow sulfur. They have even described about the different type of the different type of the mercury, and for some skin diseases. Kibrit asfar turab al zibak dust of mercury and here is the formulation the which compound contain the mercury or para am I audible to all of you now and likewise the kunash al khuz he has also described a formulation which contain the which contains the mercury for the scabies and ulcerous wounds quru radiya means very putrefied type wounds and it does like and it does kills mice likewise Yuhanna Sarabiyun it is also known as Sarabiyun wrote a medical compendium in 9th century and Girard of Cremona has translated it and it was reprinted so many times so he quoted the Razes in Al-Habi the chapter as recommending the use of killed mercury means calcined mercury zibake maktul, mixed with vinegar, khalle khamr and rose oil for the different for the skin diseases. And also he has also mentioned another mixture of mercury with arsenic for the some very challenging or very incurable diseases. Formulation is the first to contain liquid mercury rather than a derivative of the ointment. Here are some historical perspective and some overview from there they have from what era has begin it has begun and up to what status it has been given to the by the Unani physician. Here Abu Bakar Muhammad Zakaria Razi, Latinized name is Bazis. He has composed a medical encyclopedia, the comprehensive book on medicine, consists on 28th volume. Likewise, Kitabul Asrar or Sirul and the Sirul Asrar, both the books or both the treatises has extensively dealt with the mention of mercury, mercurial product preparation, and its therapeutic uses. Sirul Asrar is chiefly composed by for the detailed description of the mercury. Likewise, Kitab al Mansuri fi Atib. So he has mentioned liquid metal, zibake sabit. Zibake sabit means solidified or fixed mercury and the sublimated or musaad, sublimated and the kill mercury in the toxicology section. Ukt, fixed or solidified mercury. So I want to tell here that the Abu Bakr Muhammad Ibn Zakaria Arazi, who has composed the two treatises, Al-Asrar, Sidr Asrar, and likewise in Kitab al-Mansuri Fittib, he has described liquid metal, the sublimated and the killed mercury in the toxicology section, and how to fix the mercury and make it solid. Preparation method has also been mentioned here. Here are some diseases. I am not going into detail because time is too much short. So against some very challenging, incurable, and very complicated diseases, he has described some formulation which anyone has any interest who can see and see this ingredients and can use it for further reference it. So I have accommodated the I have put in the slide this some formulation also. Likewise, the against miasma, calf and scabies, for the vitiligo, leukoderma, even for the leprosy. Hello. Hello.
We can hear you.
Yes, you're audible, sir.
Yes, we can hear you, sir.
Yeah, thank you so much. And here the preparation method and for some diseases, some formulation which contain mercury as a chief ingredient. So likewise, Al-Qanun, Ibn Sina, it is a very famous book, and he has also described some types of the mercury and used it and mentioned it in the fifth volume and the second volume. So he has also described about the vapor of mercury, Dukhan al-Zibak or Bukhar al-Zibak. And he has mentioned in detail about the toxicity. Likewise, he has also described our living mercury, Zibak hai. And he has also mentioned that it causes no harm to most people if taken internally. And he has also described the mizaj or temperament is cold in second degree and wet in second degree. So by this, it has also decided that we can use it internally, some type of mercury. I will discuss it in detail what type of mercury we are using or what type of mercury cause some dangerous toxicity and why our used mercury in our system, what type of mercury use which is not toxic at the level which has been famous now. Likewise, the sublimated musad, you know, the seed and sublimation, and it is also extracted or separated from the cinnabar, calomel, etc. Likewise, killed mercury, he used killed mercury or calcined mercury against hematoma, macula, freckles, and melasma. Likewise, he has also used and described the dust of mercury, turab zibak, for the wet dermatophytosis, sapphire adiba. It is very challenging disease, and melasma, I think. Mercury, and the mercury was also used against lice, nits, scabies, fluorides, hematoma, macula, freckles, melasma, fistula, pain of the buttocks, and against leucoma, leucoderma, and Persian fire, Nare Farsi. And even he has described the 6 formulation in his book to tackle or to combat these challenging diseases. Likewise, Ibn al-Jazzar, who wrote the Kitab al-Itimad fil Adwiya al-Mufrida and Zad al-Musafir, he has also developed an injunction or ointment against scabies, fluorides, and said that he places as a miracle. And likewise, Ibn Sina also described some formulation of mercury as near as miraculous and incomparable. So we have to see it and we have to relook, and you have to use it and as described by the physician for this medical challenges. Likewise, Abu Ala al-Zuhar, Kitab al-Mujarrabat, he has also described 3 formulation for compound drug with mercury against vitiligo Behek. Likewise, Muhammad Idrisi, in the 12th century, describe a remedy for a compound drug against leprosy in his compendium on simple Kitab al-Jame, Lissifat, As-Sihat al-Nabat wal Anwa al-Mufradat. Likewise, Bahauddaula described an electuarium of mercury, Majun Simab, for the internal use, containing the liquid metal in his medical compendium, Hulasat al-Tajarib, written in 1501. Likewise, in 1511, Al-Yusuf described a recipe for a mercury pill, Habbe-Simab, which contained liquid mercury in his Tibbe-Therapy Yusufi. It is very interesting to know that this formulation has developed in the 16th century, and it was spread to the Istanbul, to the Europe, and it was used worldwide. I think I have Imaduddin Mahmud, Masood Mahmud al-Tabib compiled a treatise on syphilis. So the mercury has been used internally, externally, sublimated form, killed form, its dust has been used for the challenging diseases at that time. Even I have gone through a literature where I have seen that Zakaria Razi has done an experiment with the ape or monkey, and he has administered a solidified mercury. He has clutches, dances, but the this solidified mercury or fixed mercury has exceeded unaltered. So by this he deduced that the toxicity is minimal or no toxicity for the fixed mercury. Likewise, a very famous and well-known tabib or hakim, Daud al-Antaki, whose book is Tazkiratu Ulil Albab wa Al-Jami'u Lil Ajab al-Ujab, memorandum book for those who have understanding and wonderful marvels. Yeah, so this book contains an entry of mercury. He has also incorporated mercury and described it in detail in the section of simples or single drugs, and the mention also the chapter on syphilis and on pills. And he has also designated his temperament, and he has also used his for the ulcers, scabies, pleuritis, syphilis, and Persian fire, and also it has used it externally as an ointment and through fumigation, and internally in the form of pills. Mir Tufail Ahmed and Aqili both mentioned the oil of mercury. I want to stay and stress here, and I want to attract your attention here that in this subcontinent, when the Tib has came here, so they have introduced some new formulations of the mercury. Mir Tufail Ahmed and Aqili both mentioned the oil of mercury, Rogan-e Zibak or Rogan-e Simab. Even Hazara Khan has mentioned in his book Asrar-e Sina Basina, method of preparation of the oil of mercury, which at that time was prepared as burning of the clean mercury with the some kind of herbs. So like Muhammad Hussain Alvi, he has wrote the Makhzan al-Mufradat. He has a classical reference book and a very important book, Treason of Use of Single Drug. He has also mentioned about the mercury in detail. And here are some name they have mentioned in the Makhzan al-Mufradat. It is a Persian scripture, I think, and they have mentioned the different names and types and its uses and preparation method, etc. Likewise, Zakhira Khardam Shahi Sayyid Ismail Jurjani, he has also put a detailed description about the calcine mercury or Kushtay Simab. Likewise, a very prominent and renowned scholar and the court physician of in the Mughal period, Hakim Akbar Arzani, formulated Habb-e Simab and Ugd-e Simab, solidified Simab. Likewise, in this 19th century, Hakim Ajmal Khan mentioned altogether 8 different ways of purifying mercury and some formulation also. Here, in the National Formulary of India, now the 3 Jauhar, Jauhar-e Kala, Jauhar-e Simab, and Jauhar-e Tila. It has skipped somehow. I am sorry for that. Jauhar-e Kala, Jauhar-e Simab, and Jauhar-e Tala contain Simab in his formulation. As you can see, the Simab 10 gram, and Darchini Simab 25 gram in Jauhar-e Simab. So it is also mentioned in National Formulary of India, which is also successfully used for the treatment of different disorders and diseases. Either it is related to the dermatology, or it is related to the syphilis, or it is related to the some diseases of the putrefaction of the blood, and some I have already mentioned about. So what is the conclusion of this presentation? A quick review from the very beginning, even before Christ and up to the 7th century, and even up to the 19th century, a quick review reflects that importance and its successful use of the mercury to combat the complicated and incurable disease almost in all the era. We have seen they have prepared the formulation, they have used it internally and externally, they have used different types of Simab or mercury, sublimated, killed, and even the dust, even the Dukhan, the Zibak, and lastly, even Daud Antaki, which I have discussed a few minutes ago about, he has the red sublimated of the mercury, white sublimated of the mercury, and the living mercury, even Ibn Sina has stated about that. So these are the Mercury has got a central status, or a very important status or place in United System of Medicine, and they have successfully treated the complicated and challenging and some incurable diseases almost in all the era and all the traditional path, either Yunani, either even Chinese, even in some European traditions medicine I have seen. And it is a very interesting fact that the use of mercury has been prohibited in some course of time, in the history, in some countries or in some dynasty, they have prohibited, but allowed once the some unthinkable epidemic or pandemic and incurable disease prevailed, just like syphilis. Syphilis is an incurable disease, and likewise vitiligo, likewise leprosy, and likewise some skin disorder. So they have prohibited in the ST. Then some terrible and diseases and disorders came into existence and spread all over the country, they have allowed. So there is no need to worry about it. It has banned and then allowed. Likewise, the thalidomide withdrawn 1950s, when thalidomide was used by the pregnant woman, the congenital defect and the for the in the embryonic life, they have even the 10,000 to 12,000 children got defected, an embryonic defect, some embryonic type defect, and occurred by the use of, and it has been withdrawn from the in 1950. But very interestingly, it has reintroduced in 1997 as immunomodulator to some kind of disease. So always risk benefit management or strategy would be implied for that kind of matter, that either if we have tackle or combat some challenging problem, some challenging medical, some challenging disease, we can provide cure. So there will always be a risk, but risk and benefit management and proportion can be adjusted and can be built by some license. So introduce some licensing or very astringent controlled method. It can be done by the stakeholders and the policy makers. And I have gone through all the literature from since the very beginning up to the 19th century. But very interestingly, I am sharing that point with you, that Minamati disaster like condition never reported in the history through the use of mercurial compound in Yunani or Ayurveda or any system of medicine. Nobody can show me the Minamati disaster like condition by the use of, even in India we have used it in ritual and rites and in our performation of the ethical performance likewise. So there is no history of Minamati disaster like condition in history. Even I have told you that Zakaria Razi has experimented on the ape, on the monkeys by the fixed mercury, and there was no toxicity has occurred, and it has exceeded and unaltered. So I want to emphasize one more point here, that we are using the mercury after chiefly in calcined product. We use the outcome of the product is inorganic mercury, which is not toxic as the dimethyl mercury, which is known as the very dangerous neurotoxic material and elemental any elemental mercury or organic mercury. So even I have seen in the book Madanul Aksir and Karabadine and Kitabut Taklis and some books, they have mentioned 23 calcium product which can be prepared and used safely. It is other than which we have separate from the cinnabar or calomel plus kapur or shingraf. So some published research article also revealed that it is inorganic mercury that proportion is so much less from its limit. And I have also the reference, if anybody require it, I can share it. And in some recent study, it has also revealed that it is protease inhibitor and it can use against HIV and hepatitis C. It is some typographical error here, hepatitis C and other viral condition. So this is I think is a very important drug of all the traditional system of medicine. For this reason, I think it is named in Raj Ras, king of all the liquid, or Ras Raj. It is better prepare a proposal and by these references from all the traditional medicine and put. Not to gradually prohibit this very important drug of all the traditional system of medicine. Thank you so much for your patience listening. And I'm not sure that I have conveyed the message what I wanted here, but I have tried my best to have a flying view from the very beginning to the 19th century and some important milestone to show you. And thank you so much for inviting me, and thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Qazi Sahab. We are highly, highly, highly thankful of you. You have given elaborated description of the mercury, use of mercury in different diseases and its formulations. You have quoted a lot of references from different books also. This proves your depth in the knowledge of mercury. We have been joined by Dr. M.A. Wahid. Since we have deferred the inauguration of the event, so if Wahid Saab is available, he can say something and go for the inauguration, so that formal inauguration is done. Sir, aap thoda sa ye screen sharing ko band kar lijiye, Dr. Qazi Saab.
I'm sorry.
डिस्कशन बाद में चलेगा
ठीक
है वहीद साहब अस्सलाम वालेकुम आई हैव बीन योर जूनियर यू हैड बीन माय सीनियर फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम डॉक्टर एम ए वहीद हैज रिटायर्ड फ्रॉम सेंट्रल रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ यूनानी मेडिसिन हैदराबाद विच इज नाउ नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ रिसर्च इन यूनानी मेडिसिन इट वॉज हिज एफर्ट्स that led to the upgradation of the Central Research Institute to the National Institute. My words are falling very short in describing his stature. He has been conferred Padma Shri by Government of India. So he has a lot of work in vitiligo and different skin disorders. And during his tenure, Hyderabad has worked on a lot of projects, CRI Hyderabad. And he was associated with different committees of the CCRM, and he at present also he's in the board of governing body member in the CCRM. Then he's chairperson in the scientific advisory committee, and in the NSCIM also he's member of the governing body of NSCIM. I told you that my words are falling very short in describing his stature. Although he's a good friend of mine, he has been my senior, a humble senior, a guiding senior, from whom I have learned a lot. Welcome you, sir. We wish to have a few words from you to inaugurate the session. This is let me remind the speakers as well as the learned legends that this webinar is for as the world they are going to create mercury free world, but we need the mercury to prepare our medicine to for the public use, so that diseases are kept at bay. So in this regard, this webinar has been organized. Ayurveda Academia and Ayurveda industry have already done their part. Now it is the role of Unani fraternity what we can do, so that total Ayush can force the government to come with a solution. Sir, I mean, Dr. Wahid Saab, please.
Thank you very much, my dear friend Dr. Munshi, for elaborated introduction, which I don't deserve. I am one among the all Unani fraternity, not only in India, but across the India. We are working together for the propagation of the system at large. My dear friends, as my friend Dr. Munshi told you, I am audible to everyone, please.
Yes, are you audible?
We can hear you clearly.
Yeah. As my friend Dr. Munshi told, that today's webinar is, to discuss the role and the importance of the market in the different systems of Ayush systems of medicine in general and Unani medicine in particular. We all know that the role of mercury in the Greco-Islamic medicine, which referred to it to be Unani, which was practiced and which is still being practiced in Southeast Asia, especially in South Asia, the having origin in ancient Greek. As all of us know that Unani system of medicine spread to the Arabic countries and the Persian countries, entered into the India. And mercury is widely prescribed in different forms. And not only in India, but the mercury is widely used by the medical fraternity. Could be a blood pressure measuring apparatus, a temperament measuring thermometer, or in a part of the dentistry, and being used in ancient systems of medicine, including Unani system of medicine, including all other Ayush system medicine, like in the form of fumigation, topical application, and oral use. And when we talk about oral use, these drugs are used in combination with other herbal medicines, converted into a formulation where definitely it turns to be a very safe, which is well palatable, tolerated, and efficacy is established, and also the safety is established. My dear friends, all of us know, when we talk about mercury, let us know a little, get back to the traditional knowledge about the mercury. So it is known as Zibah in Arabic, a question, Sima, as my predecessor was speaking about that. And even in Urdu, it is called Sima. Plays an important role in all Indian traditional systems of medicine, including the Indian systems, including the Unani system of medicine. And there is a part and parcel of all ancient books, ancient classics. And every leading author for last at least 2000 years has a reference, very practical reference based on their clinical experiences. As I told you, they have used as a fumigation or as a topical application or as oral medication also. And there are many discourses are available in the efficacy and safety of these important mercurial preparation present in the many selection of books and written by the across authors based on the history, which is Unani system of medicine being practiced for thousands of years. Further, the use of this mercury as a single or a compound drug as a role of treatment of different diseases are being analyzed and well documented based on their clinical experiences. That means it's very successfully being treated and used and being treated with the different ailments. Now the point is where it's commonly presently used. That is something very important. Let's know there are certain surgical problems. Very specifically, I wanted to mention that my predecessors were mentioning that there's a useful in very dermatological conditions. Yes, it was, there are discourses available, and for my preferences, it was used by our ancient physicians. It's the sexually transmitted disease, especially into the syphilitic ulcers. Pruritus of any origin, and of course, true scabies also. But I wanted to highlight that there are many surgical conditions where there is no medical treatment available into the modern medicine, in spite of the well-documented classics of the modern medicines. Biological intervention to that, in spite of that, to name few, the post-burn scars. The post-burn scars, in spite of the cosmetic surgery by a good cosmetic surgeon, still there is a compromise with the quality of life and patient, and very compromise with the presence, the beauty of the person. So that will lead to the social isolation and depression. So the Unani has best to offer, and all these preparations which are there to resolve the post-burn scars is among them. All these formulations, among them mercury is a very significant ingredient to that. My dear fans, I just wanted to mention you that mercury is single as a single is could it be a fumigation, could it be a topical application or oral? It is used by a with along with the other herbal medicines. When it is used in a polyherbal formulations along with the other polyherbal formulations, when it is used, processed and used, it definitely has the lesser availability of the drug as a mercury, which is as per the permissible limit of the World Health Organization. Number one. Number two, the safety of the drug is concerned in longer time. Even for topical application, when used for a longer time and too frequently it is used, as it is to be used, as I told you, one example of post-burn scar. Post-burn scars, we are very successfully using this mercury along with the other medicines. Too frequent application and prolonged application never leaves a scar there, never compromise with the textural changes, and it does very good resolve of these burns and scar. Other than that, there's another condition called nasal polyps, you know, that surgical condition. But there are certain preparations out of this particular medicine, which is a very, very, very crown drug of which is being used in the ancient systems and including all Ayurvedic systems of medicine, like mercury is one of the very useful ingredient among that. Even there's a pile mask, which is considered to be a surgical problem. Now, Unani medicine has, in a combination of other herbs, mercury, great, great resolving effect in that. Another problem is keloid. Keloid is another surgical problem. Even, you know, there is no surgery. Any surgical intervention can definitely lift up the size of the keloid. There will be always extra granulation tissue, development of the extra granulation tissue. So the modern medicine hardly has any other treatment except giving some steroid injections into that. But that is not the radical treatment for that. That doesn't translate into the success story of taking out the keloids. So Unani has one of the best formulations which we use very successfully, which is, in the combination of certain herbal drugs along with the mercury. And not only these, any extra granulation tissues, certain conditions with any other extra granulation tissues will definitely can be treated with this particular drug, mercury, along with the in combination with the herbal drugs. My dear fans, the United States system of medicine, basically we use three types of drugs: animal origin drugs, mineral origin drugs, and the plant origin drugs. But you know, this Unani system of medicine, which give the essence of herbs or essence of minerals, means it's a mess, is a combination of drug, is a polyherbal formulation or herbal mineral drugs. Mostly 80 to 90% of the herbal mineral drugs are for external application, but the rest 10 to 20% of the drugs for oral use also. So these drugs are very useful in taking taking very rare to rarest disease. Some of my friend was mentioning about psoriasis. Some of my friend was speaking about vitiligo. Vitiligo, we do not use any product of mercury, but yes, psoriasis, I saw some of the people, they have their own experiences in treating plaques of psoriasis, psoriatic plaques. And there are CMAP, the half one brick pieces also are there, which can be that it can be separated and whole process repeated three times to make it more and more useful. So there are many methods of detoxifying methods are available in Unani system of medicine. Hikmat was the essence of Unani system of medicine. So that was the art of developing the drugs and applying the drugs onto the ailing masses. So before really giving these Sima, they have a various method of purifying this mercury. So the word purifying can take is very, very longer way and different methods, different methodologies, not only to for a single drug, but are in combination with, as I told you, with the herbal drugs. There are many methods have been given. Some people used to do it for a 3 days, soil or put into the thick cloth and squeeze it for a longer time, boil it for a longer time. There are many methods are given. So the best part I am coming to it for chronic diseases is very useful. The Unani system of medicine advocates the wider use of preparation and use of kushtas, and most strong important ingredient among these kushtas are the in addition to the other herbal drugs, one is a mercury, and the kushta sima is a one of the most renowned kushta available in the Unani system of medicine, which is considered to be very effective drug. Like along with the sambulfar, it might be which means the substance on the sublimates, which obviously makes sense in this context. However, the question about the difference of sublimation of mercury and binding is still arises. There are questions still to be answered. For example, when these drugs are used in form of kushtas, lot of transfer into the various other crystals, probably that will lead to the safety of these drugs in addition to the other. The art of the kushta is being the art of the kushta in manufacturing is being which is being developed in Unani system of medicine to make these drugs very effective and palatable, safe and effective in various conditions of larger problems like neurological disorders. It was used widely in the treatment of hemiplegia is a one condition where the Unani medicine has a discourses in their classics about the use of these drugs. So by and large, mercury is a part of the Unani system of medicine and widely used for topical application, even sometime as a fumigation, as I told, but oral medication too. In dermatology, it has a role of, as I told you, to resolve the extra granulation tissue in various conditions, psoriatic plaques too, nasal polyps, any extra growth. So it's a wonderful drug still for all surgical problems, which is not being answered. And surgical, like for a keloid, it considered to be a surgical problem that cannot be treated with the surgery. Any surgical attempt will lead to the increase into the size of the keloid because of the excessive development of the granulation tissue. So these kind of drugs are age-old drugs are very useful. I am a strong advocate of use of these products, especially made of out of mercury is strongly advocated, and not only Unani system of medicine, but it should be used in a coordination with the different system of medicine in order to develop more or more knowledge there in terms of efficacy and safety. When we talk about safety, right, the animal reports are animal studies, preclinical animal studies, in vitro studies reports are available across the net. People can definitely have the reference for that, but we can create the human safety studies. Safety not only for the into the preclinical animal studies, but cellular, at the cellular level too, and the different cells level too. The CRM Hyderabad, which was upgraded, as my friend was mentioning, that Dr. Asim Ali Khan, who is heading the Center for Research Unani Medicine, the biggest institute in Hyderabad, has the full-fledged facility for this. Probably we can take up this, and a new report, the new knowledge can be developed, and that knowledge can be transferred to the masses at large in order to disseminate this knowledge about the widely used and safety and efficacy of the mercury. Thank you very much for inviting me and giving in my time. And I'm really happy to listen to my producer, and hopefully I'll enjoy the rest of the speakers. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot, sir, for your elaborated speech.
Hello.
Speech, sir. Hello.
Hello.
Am I audible? Hello. Sir, you are audible. You are audible.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir. You are audible. Aap boliye, sir. हम सुन रहे हैं सर डॉक्टर वहीद साहब हेलो
या या डॉक्टर मुंशी हेलो
हेलो सर ऑडिबल प्लस सर प्लीज यस सर कैरी ऑन सर
कैरी ऑन सर यू आर ऑडिबल हेलो
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 हाँ वहीद साहब यू आर ऑडिबल सर प्लीज
हेलो
हेलो
हेलो आपकी आवाज आ रही है सर मेरी आवाज नहीं जा रही क्या
Hello, hello, Munshi, Dr. Munshi.
Yes, sir. You are audible, sir. Please. So, to some bad guy.
Dr. Munshi, I think there are some problems with voice, sir. सर आप शो कंटिन्यू कीजिए वेबिनार को नेक्स्ट स्पीकर को बुला के
व्हाट हैपेंड
एम आई ऑडिबल
यस सर एट दिस मोमेंट आई ऑडिबल सर
ओके ओके वहीद साहब का भी ऑडिबल है पता नहीं ये शायद सुन नहीं पा रहे
हां शायद गलती होगा कुछ होगा ऐसा टेक्निकल कुछ प्रॉब्लम हो सकता है
आई एम जस्ट गिविंग हिम अ कॉल जस्ट वेट अ मोमेंट कुछ कहना चाहते हैं तो सो नहीं देर इज सम नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम उसका कॉल भी नहीं मिल रहा है जस्ट
Hari Om, is there any problem, Dr. Parikshit?
Okay, I have talked to Dr. Vahid Saab, and he told me that he has finished his talk. Now I think if we have Dr. Idris Saab, if he has joined.
No, Idris Saab is in marriage ceremony, so he will try to join in later on.
I will invite Professor Ghulamuddin Sofi Saab, who is head.
Yes.
In pharmacology department in National Institute of Unani Medicine. Professor Sofi on this forum needs no introduction because he has already given two lectures. We had been very much obliged to him that whenever we tell him to come over the forum, and he's ready to accept. Although being so much busy, I know he's having a lot of work, academic work and administrative work also. Despite that, he has been kind enough to accept the invitation of Independent Research Society, and he's always available for the forum. Today, we wish to learn more from you, sir. I hope that the audience will also enjoy your lecture regarding the mercury and its uses, and how we can protect the whatever the industries have. The problems regarding the banning of the mercury, how that can be prevented, how we can go ahead with the government so to negotiate better outcome, better results from these. Please, sir, if Sofi Saab is there, please, you can take the mic. Over to you, sir.
Hello, good evening to all. Assalamu alaikum and namaste. I'm again overwhelmed by your introduction. Basically, whatever we have heard.
Sir, do you have presentation also?
Sir, I had my presentation, but my this.
Okay, you can go ahead like that. Nothing doing, sir. You can go ahead. Nothing doing.
Can I? Yes. One minute. I was joining this my laptop. I don't know whether it has joined or not. Yes, I think I am joined. No. Okay, sir. I will let from my this phone only, because I am unable to join this laptop.
Continue, sir. Continue, sir.
Basically, I had prepared for this Kushta a potent Unani drug dosage formulation. This mercury as a the Kushta of mercury which we are using, Dr. Zaid, my student and a prestigious position at AMU Aligarh in the field of pharmacy, he put forward several things which I had prepared, but it is my luck that he told them in an elaborate way, and he said various researches also which were very important for us to know it. But basically, let us see what is the scope of Kushta in Unani medicine. When we say that medicine or a drug, we say that it is the part of pharmacotherapy when we are going for this treatment in Unani medicine. Pharmacotherapy is basically it lies at the third step of the treatment module when Unani is concerned. We usually go for large bill Gaza, and then we go for regimental therapy, and if the patient needs the drugs, then we go for pharmacotherapy as a treatment. Since the diseases are compound in nature, they have the causes which are more than two causes are involved in causation of a disease, we say it a Markov disease. That time we need the intervention of drugs also. When we use the drugs in Unani medicine, either we treat it by single drugs or by compound formulation. When we use it as a single drug, we call it ilaj bil mufarad. And when we use more than one drugs in a particular form, more than one drugs in a particular form, then we say that we are using the compound drug formulation for the treatment of a disease. There are 65 dosage formulation in Unani medicine as per Sharif Khan's book is. Hello, sir. Am I audible?
Ji, we can. Sophie ji, we can hear you.
Okay, thank you, sir. As per Sharif Khan's book, Ilajul Amraz, we have 65 dosage formulations in Unani system of medicine. There are about 2 lakh documented prescriptions that serve base for the formulations. These 2 lakhs have been documented at TKDL for Unani medicine. And there are so many others which are yet to be formulated. Still, there are vacancies going on in TKDL for documenting those prescriptions or those medicines. Kushta formulations are about 200 in number, among which mercury is used in 30 formulations, which is a very huge amount. And we are using it for several diseases. It can be the disease, it can be used internally, it can be used topically, and it can be used for various systems where systems are affected. But basically, our this Kushta, which involves mercury, it is used in very serious diseases like paralysis. Even post-stroke patients, they are getting cured using the mercury Kushta, which is very important when we see its management in conventional medicine, which is very much bleak, and the patient has to be dependent to his relatives or his caregivers for lifetime. When we use this mercury, we use mercury as a sulfide of mercury, which has been always a non-toxic entity. About 3% of the formulations involve the use of inorganic substances, mainly as ore or compounds, and among them we have mercury also. With this introduction, when we say this, we are using this mercury. How we will relate it in Unani medicine? There are basically 2 schools of thought in Unani medicine. One is the Lucknow school of Unani tip, which strongly negates use of Kushta preparations. They basically say that whatever is safe, the most safe, that should be used. And if we don't have any safe drug, we can go to Kushta. And they have their formularies, their bias, their personal compendium for drugs. Most of them, they contain this medicine, and very less it has this animal-based medicine. Kushta have been rarely used by Lucknow school of thought. Then we have another equivalent school of thought, Delhi school of thought, which had admired this Kushta equally as Unani, this Lucknow school has negated. They propound 10 reasons for the use of Kushta as a potent Unani drugs. They have propounded that they can be used for chronic ailments, for ailments where hararate garizya diminished and need to be rejuvenated as a rejuvenator, which is very important action of a drug, which we don't find in any conventional terms. Then there are quicker actions of the drug. This Kushta has very quicker action, and we have seen that they can be in the range of nanoparticles. Most of the studies which we are seeing, about 100 studies which I have gone through since yesterday, they have related these actions, these fast acting actions, for this nanoparticle size of the Kushta. And then severity of disease is the last stage, when it is in the last stage and needs to be arrested, and we want to the patient to get a better cure, we always fall on to Kushta. So it is very important. It is very important that Kushtas cannot be banned, and when they are used classically, how can we ban them? Now the problem is that why we are using it when we have the other safe drugs. Basically, when we say safety, Unani medicine or any other traditional system, it has inherent safety locks in its management strategy. Even when we were discussing about pharmacovigilance, we had a question like that. When there are inherent internal safety measures in traditional systems, why to go for the pharmacovigilance? Though the pharmacovigilance people have the reasons why traditional system be involved in pharmacovigilance, and we have the mechanism, for example, inorganic substance like a different thing than any other inorganic substance like mercury. We are just processing them. We have never used inorganic elemental metals in our system, and they have never been used till date. Whenever we have used any metal, we have always treating them with some booty or with some herb, with the juice of a herb or with alum, so that we have converted them. We have converted into what I may call the organometallic substance or organometallic entity. This organometallic entity, it has a very much resemblance with our body. So this is very important stage when we say that we are not using this elemental, or we say we are using this elemental metals. Then why this ban of mercury? You want to see the world free of mercury. Why this ban should come to us? This ban is similar when we say that some heavy metals which are allowable in the body, still we say these heavy metals have very much side effects, and the people are saying that you should know the heavy metal content in the drugs. So it is okay, but when we are in the way of drugs, then we cannot say that the rules which have been applied, when we are stating that for any other drug, what is its heavy metal content, when we are using these heavy metals in the system or in the management of diseases, we cannot be governed by those rules, and those rules cannot trap us for using these, for not using these metals. So important is that our scenario of using these metals, it has not been discussed. During 2015 or 16, World Health Organization, it just proceeded with a recommendation that we should free whole of the world from mercury. So then onwards, this problem started for us. This problem, when it starts, then its member countries, they have to take certain actions. And we have seen mostly very, very few days before, our government, this commerce and industry ministry, it is trying to ban all the mercury products. But one thing should be clear to them, that when it is being banned, mercury, quintal mercury is being banned, why the drug as a drug, when traditional system is using it, why it should be banned when it is helping thousands and thousands of people for very these diseases, for various ailments which are very chronic, which don't have any conventional adequate treatment, why it is being used? So this here is the problem, that they are not understanding our perspective, and they are using their own methodological relations or methodological inferences, and just saying that it is one of the system or these are the traditional systems, they are using mercury and they should be banned. That is the problem where we need to assert ourselves. This assertion can be done in more than two, three ways. Either we have to fight at governmental levels, or we have to show them that by research, we can show them that these are not that much problematic which you were thinking. On this line, people had written several things. Even in JAMA, we are seeing the debate of this use of mercury, whether it is harmful or whether it is useful. Basically, it was the paper JAMA which has started us. to think about these problems, that it is a problematic. But later on, various answers were also given, and a debate was there. But this premature ban, it simply made this debate worthless, useless. Even in our institutions, as Hamiduddin, Dr. Hamiduddin will be conveying us those things, we have used mercury and found that they are quite safe. And even when we are processing them, the lost product, it shows very negligible mercury. So this thing is very important for us before going into the analysis of this traditional systems. These people should not, the government should not have taken the decision of the blanket ban on mercury. Then we have various these problems. What will be the effect of this blanket ban or import ban on the imports? Basically, it will import the traditional industry. We all are in this great depression, economic depression. Still, we are going for, if we are going for the ban on mercury, I think 30 to 40% of Ayurveda sales of these drugs, they will get affected. And even 3 to 6% of Unani drug sales will get affected. Then there will be effect on patients also. The patient's effect will be like that. The diseases where people come to us with a hope that we will cure them. And we will not have the product for them. And we will simply say them, sorry, government has not given us the permission that we can make this drug now. So it was a very important drug in our system. Though mercury, I said previously that it has a very good effect on paralysis caused by thrombosis, or there is post-stroke rehabilitation. We can use it because it has not yet been used extensively by other people. Though we have convincing observations that it is effective in these cases. Then for those things where we have debility, general debility, when we are using this mercurous substances, they get okay, they get the cure, what they want. So this is the scenario where we have to be very serious why this mercury ban should be there. If they want to ban, they should have a research. At least they should know the perspective of traditional systems, where we have inherent mechanism of safety of our drugs. Not only these plant drugs, we have very much adequate safety measures for these drugs of or inorganic nature. It is very important. We need to assert people, assert the these higher authorities in our government, that ours is a different way of looking at metals, looking at mercury especially. We have a specific way of doing the things, how we do it and why it is safe. We are not using the mercury, that ore of mercury which is dangerous. We are using the sulfide mercury, the shingraf, or we are using the al-ahmar. They are the sulfide ores of mercury, which are very much safe to the body, as proven by various studies. So here it is important that we have to bear these things in mind. Then again, one thing more which is very important, which I would like to stress, if today mercury is being banned because it is a heavy metal, it is a toxic metal, it just goes inside the body and it accumulates, it is an accumulative poison, then what about arsenic? And then what about the nickel and lead and zinc and other things? If you ban one thing, tomorrow we will be banned for another thing. So it is not the case of only mercury which we are talking of. Basically, we are talking of that okay, let there be several criteria on which you can select what to ban and what not to ban. But at least you remember that there is a traditional medicine view on these things, which is well documented. It was not well documented 10 years ago. It was not well documented 20 years ago. We had traditional claims only. But now the literature has come for our side also. At least it should be looked at, and this then should be done away with. With these words, thank you, sir, very much giving me the time. I thank Dr. Yunus Munshi and Dr. Pawan sir for giving me this opportunity at least to discuss this simple question. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Professor Sophie sir. You had elaborated all the things, what to do and what not to do, and how we can come out of all these things by approaching the request. Our next speaker, Dr. Hamiduddin, who is assistant Sadullah, which is pharmaceutical practices in National Institute of United Medicine, Bangalore. Hello, am I audible?
Yes.
Okay, so Professor Hamidu, who is assistant professor in NIM, National Institute of United Medicine, a prestigious institute of the United Medicine in Bangalore. I hope that he will give us the brief regarding the mercury, its use, its purification, then how we can proceed with the government to help the Ayush fraternity out of this what we term as illegal ban of the, which is being used in the Ayush system of certain diseases on this on the mercury product. So over to you, Dr. Hamid Saab, please.
Good evening, everybody. Audible to all?
Sir, you are not audible. Dr. Hamiduddin, sir, you are not audible.
Yes, sir. Hello.
Yes.
Hello. Am I audible to now?
Yes, sir. Audible, sir. Yes, sir.
My screen is displaying.
Yes, your slide is being seen. Okay, Dr. Amit.
सब इसको आप स्लाइड शो मोड में ला लीजिए प्लीज.
ओके.
हाँ यस.
सॉरी फॉर द डिस्टरबेंस.
ऑडिबल आल्सो एंड
नाउ. Hello,
sir. Your audible, nice. But it's very sound is very slow.
Just a minute. Now sound is okay. Hello.
Yes, sir. Audible, sir.
And sound is okay.
Clear.
Yes, sir.
Your slides are visible. Your slides are visible. You are able. Everything is okay. You can go ahead.
Good evening, everybody. I will brief my presentation. You will tell me for that. Utilization of Shangrak, and my topic is particularly on the red sulfide of mercury, therapeutics of nine medicine, which is safety assessment. We have done some work on this here as a national. That also I will be presenting you with. As you all know, Shangrak, I will actually skip the matter already seen by previous speaker. Everybody is aware regarding Shangrak, the number, the red sulfide of mercury, and Dr. Sufi well explained the use of Shangrak in syphilis, particularly in Nigeria and all. And it requires extensive assessment. Safety and pollution due to presence of mercury, because it is the ore of mercury. And as you all know, that in the long term of Sinabar, 1,000 years back, any mercury containing mercury and compound have been banned or restricted in some countries. Toxicity of mercury, as we know very well, is a toxic component, and organic mercury causing future are mental retardation. The first order account of animal experimentation is actually on the toxicity goes to Ravi in 1910. And silver ointment was used by Arabs for the treatment of the disease. But the treatment also includes pills and ointments of sublimated and calomel. Regarding safety assessment in history, several studies suggest protect cinnabar as non toxic, safe, and effective in acute toxicity studies. And cinnabar, as you all know, that it is insoluble in poorly absorbed form. That is that its solubility and bioavailability is quite low. It is used generally as an ingredient.
Please be loud.
It is used generally as an ingredient with other drugs. Metal oxides are more toxic in comparison to sulfide form. Am I okay? Sound is it?
Ji, still the voice is still very weak. Ji, agar bina microphone kare to.
Is it okay now?
Nahi ji, thoda disturbance ho raha.
I'll change the microphone. Sir, the dusra microphone aana tha.
Thank you.
So basically, Dr. Saab, basically, bandwidth zyada leta hai. Agar aap video off rakhenge, to ho sakta hai sound quality improve ho jaye.
Okay.
वैसे हेडफोन में तो अच्छा सुनाई देता है लेकिन पता नहीं स्पीकर में शायद नहीं सुनाई देता होगा सिंस आई एम यूजिंग हेडफोन सो आई एम गेटिंग क्लियर साउंड ओके सो आई डोंट नो whether इट इज ओके फॉर डॉक्टर मदन साहब प्लीज इज इट ओके इफ इट इज ओके तो यू कैन टू मी इट इज ओके बिकॉज आई एम me it is okay because using headphones and I don't know whether Dr. Madan Saab okay is now. Having some yeah it is okay to me it is okay
I don't know. Clear
Why? It is because of I'm using headphones and mic of that. But डॉक्टर साहब आपके पास अगर हेडफोन हो यू कैन यूज हेडफोन्स एंड देन वी मे सी इफ वी कैन गेट क्लियर सो ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स प्लीज बियर विद अस ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स प्लीज बियर विद अस
थैंक यू जी
थैंक यू यस इट इज ओके टू मी इट इज ओके आई डोंट नो फॉर द अदर्स
ओके नाउ
या गो गो अहेड गो अहेड गो अहेड सर गो अहेड सर
Here that unless and until the salt is dissociated into constituent ion, this mercury will not be able to exert its influence on body tissue. Now, Cinnabar is reported to be the most inert form of mercurial compound and has been found to exhibit 5,000-fold less toxicity when compared with methyl mercury based on the result obtained after exposure of brain and liver for 48 hours to cinnabar containing traditional Chinese medicine. I'm referring to studies here. Studies show that cinnabar can be transformed into mercury polysulfide rather than methyl mercury. Under gut flora signature. Cinnabar contains more than 96% of HGS and methylation of cinnabar by microbe. The gut is impossible because of poorly soluble mercuric sulfide as it can be hardly release mercury ions in the water. Now what if we have a different into form that can imbibe medicinal import. Medicinal property into it. But the caution we have to take is that the long-term use of cinnabar containing traditional medicine can result in renal dysfunction, blurred vision due to accumulation of mercury in kidney, brain, and kidney. Symptoms include injury to liver and kidney also. This is, all things goes to the, we know the intrinsic activity of mercury which all has been documented. It's all caused due to oxidative stress caused by mercury in the body. Now, the exposure on heating. If we heat cinnabar during preparation, these formulations can result in release of mercury vapor, which in turn can produce toxicity to the surrounding person due to inhalation of these vapors. Overdose and long-term use of chandrama are major cause of mercurial intoxication, but at therapeutic dose, it has adverse effects in traditional medicine. Tolerable and reversible. Now, what we find is use of chandra in Yunani medicine. So we can classify it as in a non-incinerated chandra and incinerated chandra. So what we see, near about 200 formulations of chandra were found on review of Yunani tests other than Pushta, that is incinerated form or calcined form. Majority of the formulations were indicated for topical or local use in the form of ointment, liniment, etc. Formulation containing 50% and more than 50% quantity of chandra are about 18, just 18 in number. These findings indicate that most of the non-incinerated formulations of chandra are being used locally and only very few formulations have large quantity of chandra. Second category is use of chandra in Yunnani medicine is in incinerated form or you can say N2 form. Either calcined or roasted form. So review indicates that there are about 117 incinerated and 50 roasted, we say mukallas and tashbiya, chandra preparation are being mentioned in important Yunani texts in the name of ham chandra or tashbiya chandra. Besides this, chandra is being also used as an ingredient in there about 7 mica of other mineral and metal in incinerated form, making a total of 274 incinerated chandra carbonate. So this review clearly indicates that chandra is mainly used in non-carbonate in the form of pushta, that is bhasma, and majority of raw chandra preparation is generally used locally. So I will not go in the detail of the use, as they mentioned by Dr. Zair and Dr. Tutu himself. There are we have to see the risk benefit assessment for this therapeutic use. And as several important indications are being mentioned, which can mention in one medical treatment, paralysis, it is stimulant to say tonic to brain, heart and kidney, syphilis and blood disorder, severe skin diseases, vitiligo, leprosy, asthma, etc. And these are the important indications. I am not going through all the indications here. What we see that apart from other indications, there are some you can say indications which can be avoided, that is premature agitation and production of semen and all, appetizer, growing of face and all, and coryza. These indications can be avoided to use. When you see chandra is being used in many other metal and pushta preparation, besides direct use, direct bhasma, it is used in other bhasma of other drugs also, just as like pushta polat, pushta faksul hadith, pushta nukra, pushta tila, pushta samulpar, arsenical pushta, and I am given it in decreasing order. So majority of the chandra is being used in pushta polat. Now, what we see, pushta chandra prepared by incineration at higher temperature, this is our assumption, maybe safer for consumption than roasted or heated preparation at lower temperature because of evaporation of mercury. Now, what we have done, this was one of my students, Dr. Akhtar Ali, get the plan for dissertation work for just see the physical presence of mercury after physicochemical analysis, detail analysis, XRD, ICQMS, ICOS and other sophisticated tests at IISc and other accredited laboratory of Bangalore. So what we found that we had taken four type of samples. First, we had taken a cinnabar powder plain sample and we had run in the XRD and we clearly see the cinnabar peak in that is HPS peak. All the peak are of cinnabar. Secondly, we had used processed cinnabar after Shodhana, as we say in Ayurveda and Mudabbar, as we say in Yunani medicine, we have processed in say 12 hours with the lime, citrus juice. So what we found that there is no change after process also, and still we found the presence of cinnabar in ecstatic. Second, then what we had done, we had taken on formulation containing jaipal and alum and that is chandra, that is singula, cinnabar, and we had processed it and we together we had made the calcine preparation by classical as well as muffled furnace, both the method. So in both the method, what we had seen that incinerated chandra with curry and jaipal, what we find it is the aluminium oxide preparation we find. There is no presence of mercury. As XRD, sulfur has been not been detected. So we had used another test for detecting the sulfur also. So we doesn't find any mercury content in XRD test. Then we had done other evaluation also, other tests also, ICPOVS, ICPMS, XRD and some gravimetric method for sulfur detection. What we find is like in both the preparation classically as well as in muffle furnace, we find 24% sulfur and 22% sulfur in both the preparation. And we find mercury totally not detected in both the samples, in ICPOES and ICPMS also, and even in XRD also. And instead, we find some arsenic at 3 ppm. Iron, we find 1146 ppm. Lead, we find under permissible limit. Cadmium, we find under permissible limit. And aluminium, we find in higher quantity because of presence of alum in that. Besides, we found calcium, sulfur, and other minor elements. Now, One thing, we are claiming that incinerated Chandra, cinnabar, more than above 600 degrees, in this case, we had incinerated up to 900 degrees centigrade. So we had not found trace of mercury in above 900 degrees centigrade temperature. Besides this, we have another method where we are roasting it on slight heat. By that procedure, what we found, mercury in the XRD. This is the mercury roasted with alum, not incinerated at higher temperature. And in this case, we found mercury, cinnabar peak in XRD study. So what we can conclude from this study is that Pushtai Chandra by cinnabar is part of several commonly used marketed formulations. Very important formulation, and we all know that Dibicon is very important for formulation from Himalaya for diabetes. It contains Chandra in very small quantity. And there are several formulations in Ayurvedic medicine also and Ayurvedic where these are commonly marketed in the and contain small amount of Chandra. So very less is known about its toxicity, kinetic or toxicological profile till now, even though so many studies have been done. Further sophisticated evaluation is needed. A majority of Chandra preparation found in United States are in incinerated form. Incinerated formulation can probably be a safe option than roasted or heated preparation prepared at lower temperature because of the operation of mercury in the former. So we can conclude it that rationale for its use may need further justification. Caution is needed due to some reported toxicity study. Precaution in manufacturing and proper disposal of fumes is needed. And SOP can be laid down for the same. Because sometimes using the highly integrated Chandra for Hingula preparation is very less toxic when comparison to persons who are exposed in manufacturing this. So we should adopt some method to capture the fume and mercury deposit which is volatilizing. So that it could not disperse in the environment, not causing harm to the outer world, and it should be limited to the manufacturing space and safely disposed of from there. So if this can be done, and detail of several works that discuss its solubility, absorption, toxic effect can be very essential for this benefit assessment. A lot of work has been done by which we can clearly assess whether it is indicated in X disease or in Y disease. On the basis of risk benefit assessment, it can use. Its use can be redefined but cannot be restricted due to unavailability in the market due to regulatory guidelines. Thank you very much for taking.
Thank you very much, Dr. Hamiduddin Saab. We are highly thankful of you for giving us the insight of the mercurial products and mercury. We have been in the webinar for the last, I think it is now 2 hours. So we have another presentation, and then we will open for the discussion, group discussion. If Dr. Pawan Saab, if Idris Saab has joined, hello.
Munishi sir, Pawan sir is yet to join. I think he is still struggling. He's on the way.
Okay.
You please contact and continue with our speakers.
Idris saab ne join kiya hai kya? Can you see that? Can you inform me like that?
Idris
I don't see his name there. I don't know
whether yes, sir, he's joined his or not. His name is also not showing, sir.
So that means he has not joined yet. So let us move to another speaker till if we will see if Dr. Idris Saab can join us. Now we have Dr. Shahid Chaudhary, who is Assistant Professor, Department of Sadullah, School of Unani Medical Education and Research, Jamia Hamdard University, which is called. Dr. Shahid Chaudhary, as you know, Ilmul Saadullah is known as pharmaceutical practices, where we teach the students. I don't know what it is called in Ayurveda, but here pharmaceutical practices are being taught to the students, how to purify the medicine, toxic medicine, and then how to prepare them, how to make compound medicine, how to combine different, how to add correctives to the medicine. These all the things are being taught in Ilmul Sadullah, and this branch of has been just four or five years back introduced in the United States postgraduate courses. Earlier it was not as a specialty. We have Dr. Shahid Chaudhary Saab with us. Dr. Chaudhary Saab, please, over to you, because we are short of time. And I'm sorry, I'm not having your full bio data. It is with Pawan Saab, and Pawan Saab has not joined. I'm sorry that I am not able to give your detailed introduction, for which I feel very sorry towards Dr. Hamiduddin also and Dr. Chaudhary Saab also, because I don't have your bio data. So please go ahead, sir, please. Sir, up, unmute kar lijiye. Your slides are visible. Your slides are visible. Clearly visible.
Now am I audible, sir?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
You are audible also. Please go ahead.
Okay, sir. Thank you for the introduction, sir. Thanks the organizers for calling me for this wonderful webinar, where and I'm also very pleased that I am sharing the platform with my respected teachers, as Professor Sufi and Dr. Hamiduddin are my teachers at NIUM. So before I go to my presentation, that most of the things have been covered by the respected speakers, as Dr. Zaid has already told about the Kushta and the CMAB and the mercury and the uses of mercury from the very beginning till the 19th century. So I feel that I took the path from 19th century to the latest one. So what I have chosen to present to you, that what are the different formulations in authoritative books which we have in our Unani system of medicine. So what I mean by authoritative books, that the books which are mentioned by the Drug and Cosmetic Act schedule first, these are the 14 books, and these are the authoritative books. Authoritative in the means that when any manufacturing unit or any pharmaceutical industry wants to market his or her product in market, then the company must have to give reference from these authoritative books only. So these are the very important books from the legal perspective. So I will mention the different formulations of mercury, as well as the compounds of the mercury which are mentioned in these Unani authoritative books. So if we see the introduction of the mercury, as already have told by the respected speaker Dr. Z, that we have numerous of synonyms and pronyms for the mercury, and each and every name which we have for mercury in our Unani literature is indicated of its property or the characteristic. And in Unani system of medicine, it is mainly, if we talk about the CMAB, that is, it is a Persian word which is used for the para, or in Arabic we said zabak. So the Unani formulations, basically especially the CMAB formulations, are mainly muqawwiya badan, dafi amraz balghami, musaffiya khoon, muqawwiya ba, mumsik wa mughalliz. So these are the different forms of mercury, Sometimes we use the purified mercury, sometimes in the form of Raskapur or Shingra or Darchina. So before going to formulate any product or any formulation of mercury, it is highly indicated and recommended that the purification process should be started at first. And there are numerous methods for the purification, or we can say mudabbar. Method of mudabbar is mentioned in our literature, but these are the three methods which are mentioned by the Unani Pharmacopoeia of India, or these are the three methods which are mentioned in the National Formulary of Unani Unani Medicine. So, as Dr. Munshi has already told at the beginning, that we have very limited dosage forms. I think that we have Kajali, and so when we go to the literature, we found that not only the Kushta is the dosage form which we use CMAB in the forms, but there are other dosage forms which are mentioned in Unani literature, especially the authoritative books. So it ranges from pills to tablets, sublimates, oils, liniments, ointments, paste, and many more, which you can find in these literature. First, if we see in the National Formulary of Unani Medicine, it is a book which was compiled by the government of India, and it was compiled by the Unani Pharmacopoeial Commission. So the book was compiled by the different Qarabadins, or the traditional pharmacopoeias. So if we see the NFUM first, so we found there are numerous formulations of CMAB, that is mercury, as well as calomel or cinnabar. And some of the indications which are very surprising for me when I go through the literature, that as you can see, that habbe miskin nawaz, the first one is mentioned, it is in the pill form. It is indicated in the samane mufrit, that is obesity. So such type of indications, we always go through that the formulations of CMAB or the mercury are useful in skin disorders or in sexual disorders. But here it is indicated in national formulary that it is used for the samane mufrit. Similarly, there are numerous formulation in second part. These are formulations which also used in the ointment form or the sublimate form, that is called Johar in Unani system of medicine.
Slides are not moving. We are still at National Formulary of Unani Medicine, part
slides
1.
Slides are not moving.
Your slides are not moving. Yeah. Now we have NFUM part 3. Okay. Okay.
But here it shows the Unani NFUM part 3.
Yes, part 3 is now visible. Part 3 is now visible. We are at NFUM part 3. We are at part 3 yet. Now it is part 4. Yes, it is part 4 now.
Now it is part 4, sir.
Yeah, it is part 4 now. Please go ahead.
So in NFUM part 4, you can see the numerous formulations of mercurial formulations. As I told earlier, that when I go through the literature, I found some unique indication also. Like in Kushtai Shingraf, I found that Zaktuddam Zaif, it is indicated in Zaktuddam Zaif, that is in hypotension, it is indicated. Or it is for the Fakruddam, that is for anemia. And even like Kushtai Darchikne in different types of lymphadenopathies, and it is also useful for. So all are mentioned in the national formulary, and this is the national formulary part 5. In this formula, four different formulations are mentioned, and in six these eight formulations
part are mentioned. Part 5,
if you go to the next,
has not come up. Part 5 has not come up. Yes, we are at 6 now. Hello.
Oh, sir. Yes, sir. Now the next
part six.
City book is the Qiyas.
Yes, it is okay.
Now the next book is the authoritative book. These authoritative books are used by the practitioners, and even the manufacturers also take reference from this book only. And NFUM, these are two books, these 14 books which are mentioned here. There are numerous formulations which are prescribed or which are mentioned in Bayaz-e-Kabir. It is also ranges from pills to liniments to the kushta, and even the powder form of drugs are also used, and for they are indicated for numerous of disease, starting from skin disease to neurological disorders, as Dr. Sufi has mentioned that for phalange, that is paralysis, they are also indicated. And the next book, which is mainly considered as the book of the kushta, and there are numerous formulas of kushta are mentioned. This is the Miftahul Khazain. Here, different forms are also mentioned, like the salaya and like uqd or shaguft, as Dr. Hamiduddin sir mentioned that shaguft is the roasted form. So here the 20 formulations which are in the form of salaya. Salaya is mercury with other herbs for long durations. For pehar, it is mentioned that for 8 pehar jo hai isko kharal kiya jata hai, theek hai. So itna for a long duration when also I would like to mention that not always we use the fire or the high flame for making the formulations, as we normally it is thought that with the intense fire. But on the other side, we also have other options. It is prepared like kushta, but low fire or the low temperature is given to the formulation. Similarly, here you can see that it is useful in the cataract. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, we can hear you, Dr. Saeed.
Okay, sir. Thank you. So it is also a unique indication. It is mentioned that it is useful in the cataract, that it is locally applied. It is in powder form and it can be locally applied. And uqd is also a new form, or we can say a novel or a unique type of formulation. It is mentioned that it is a very potent aphrodisiac, and it should be used in the form of gutka or in the form of pill and kept in the mouth so that it can affect, and it is needed in the premature ejaculation. Similarly, these are also, there are 24 formulations of salaya in this book of cinnabar, that is shangraf, and 25 formulations of roasted shangraf, and sublimate of shangraf, two formulations. And these are the formulations of Riz Kapoor. And the other book, which is also considered as a book of kushta, is the Kitab Madanul Aksir. In this book, there are 20 formulations of the Kushta Para, that is, Kushta of mercury is mentioned, and it is useful for all types of Barid Vartab Amraz. And Kushta Shangraf is also 27 formulations of Kushta Shangraf and 5 formulations of Kushta were all mentioned. And, fourth book is the Kitabut Taqis. The author of the said book is Hakim Kabiruddin Saab, and this book was written in the early of the 20th century, and they mentioned the 24 formulations of Kushta Simab and 40 formulations of Kushta Shingraf. And similarly here he also mentioned that it is useful in cataract, leprosy, leukoderma, gonorrhea, and all other baras. One book which is also authoritative book is the Sanatu Taklis. It is also the book of the Kushta. In this book, there are 15 formulations of Kushta Shangraf is mentioned, and 3 for Kushta Darchin. Other than this, they also the author also mentioned detailed description of Simab mercury, how to obtain, what are the synonyms, what are the method of preparations, what are the toxicity. Also mentioned toxicity. If the is not standard or not as per indicated way, then it may be toxic. It is clearly mentioned in every book. Then next one is the Kharabadina Qadri. It is also mentioned in the 17th chapter of this book, which is mainly written for the body. It also mentioned different formulations for many diseases, for PME, for penile erection. And in chapter 20, which is mainly dedicated for the skin diseases, they also mentioned different formulations. And if we go in this, most of the part was cut. So I would like to mention here that century, this is a book which was wrote by Abu Sarattar Asraili, and it was this book is considered is of great value in pharmaceutics. If we go through the 16th chapter of the liniments, he also mentioned the liniment of mercury, which is be useful for skin. So all these things, if I want to talk, there are numerous of formulations which are present mentioned in our authoritative. These are authoritative government of India has. So these have the legal value. Anything which is out of these books, if any we have any formulation but we have not any reference from these books, then we cannot use such formulation. So in these 4 to 7 books which I have mentioned here, I go through more than 325 of different formulations in which Simab, that is mercury, or its ores are being used. And it is also mentioned that they are the highly drugs. If the of mercury is per the classical text, then it is also mentioned that there is no need for any medicine or any type of other medicine if the Kushta of mercury is prepared as per the text. And as we said that from head to toe, all the disease have been covered by these formulations. So as I already told that if it is not prepared as per the text or if or not the guidelines have been followed, then we all ultimately the patient may suffer the side effects or the toxic effects may come. Because when we make a kushta or any formation or any natural long, the mercury is not present in the free form. It will binds. So it will not as toxic as it is it in free form. So what I recommend that, but what we can see that they are very limited use of these mercurial preparations right now in our clinical practice. So the physician should be should use these formulations especially for skin diseases and the neurological disorders like Fallage, Lakva, and even these sexual diseases like PAP. We can see that only this limited number formulation are come in market, especially in Yunani of medicine, some tila, but there are many more formulations which should be used. And a need of research is always there, and the scope is always there for the safety and toxicity studies, so that we can use these products judiciously. So it is all about rather has been covered by my respected teachers. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Great, sir. Great. Though I was not involved actively, but I was listening each and every lecture. Really, it is very informative session. No doubt, Sai ji. I regard excellent. Your presentation is also excellent, and way of communication is also excellent. Excellent, excellent. All experience, Munshi ji. If you would like to say something, Dr. Yunus Munshi ji. Munshi ji.
I don't have words. Yes. When Dr. Pawan. Hello. Am I audible?
Yes.
I don't have words. So naturally, ball is in your court. You go ahead. Please see.
So,
if,
I would like to communicate my really Dr. sincere thanks to Dr. Yunus Munshi ji and all expert speakers, Vahid Sahib, Kaji Sahib, Hamimuddin Sahib, Shahid Sahib. So I'm really grateful and thankful, though. We have missed today Dr. Wadood and Dr. Idris Ali, sir. We will be definitely requesting them to join us again. But today, really excellent lectures. And now I would like for expert comment before respected Madan Thangvelu ji and V.K. Agnihotri ji, I would like to request Dr. KRC Reddy, head of the department, Ras Shastra department, professor, IMS, PHU. Welcome, Dr. Reddy. We would like to hear about your expertise and your view on the same subject. Please guide us.
Thank you, Pawanji. Is it I am audible?
Yes, clear.
Thank you. Thanks to Dr. Pawan Kumar Sharma ji and also all the experts of Yunani system, particularly Dr. Wahid ji, whom I know very well. When I was working as director for Pharmacopoeia Commission of Indian Medicine and Homeopathy in Ghaziabad, that time I used to have talk with all Yunani pharmacopoeia experts and also Asim Ali Khan, who was the Director General of OCCRUM. And with this interest, I requested Pawan Kumar Sharma ji to have a session on mercurial products in Unani system also. Just a few information I want to give regarding Ayurveda and mercurial products. In Ayurveda, the mercurial products are enlightened and described very elaborately in the specialization called Rasa Shastra. The mercurial products we call as Rasaushadhis. And these Rasaushadhis, since 8th century in Indian subcontinent, we have used for the treating many of the complicated, untreatable disease conditions very efficiently, and also with a smaller dose, they have proven their efficacy. Present day, we have conducted some of the researches in Ayurveda, and these researches very clearly shows that. Now I am showing one of the research paper which is available in internet, the plant medicated detoxification of mercury and lead. Actually, we call the Sodhana process. With this detoxification of specific pharmaceutical procedure, which is called Sodhana, the mercury is processed. And then it will be combined most of the times with sulfur components. The best example we call Kadzali, where mercury and sulfur are combined together, and the compound again further mixed with many of the plant materials. Finally, herbo mineral formulation will be prepared. Similarly, we also use cinnabar, we call it Hingul. And that is again, it is a HGS, mercury and sulfide, mercury sulfide form. That also we are using for preparing many of the rasaushadhis, herbo mineral products of Ayurveda, and they are used since ages, and they found very efficacious. And also these information was transferred later to the China also, and the Chinese system also developed this Rasasra as a part of Chinese medicine. Presently, many of the researches we conducted regarding the safety of the mercurial products of Ayurveda, and also many of the pharmaceutical procedures, the chemical identity as well as the analytical studies also very efficiently conducted. Some of the few studies which we conducted in our BHU and other parts of the country, I will show you. Before showing that, now the present problem is that mercury poisoning, and this was raised by the worldwide some of the scientist forums. In mercury poisoning, the major causative sources as per the scientific study worldwide has been identified that main consumption of mercury through fish consumption. Fish, which is taking the water in the seas and rivers, which the water which is polluted with factory byproducts, where the mercury is also get transmitted through water to the fish. If that fish has consumed, the mercury toxicity has been found. That is what Minamata issue has been raised. Another issue is that dental amalgams. In previous days, for filling the caries tooth, the doctors use mercury amalgam as one of the filling material in the tooth. That ultimately slowly releases the mercury in the body, so finally toxicity has been produced. Some of the vaccines and also increased metallic mercury in vaporous form. If mercury is inhaled in form of vapors, in the form of gaseous form of mercury, inhalation is causing the toxicity. So this is the claim of modern scientists. However, what I would like to say that since I was working as a director for Pharmacopoeia Commission, I had a touch with pharmacopoeial, Unani pharmacopoeial experts, and Ayurveda, I belong to Ayurveda itself, that too specialization of mercurial compounds, that is called Rasyasra. Nowhere in our Ayurveda and Unani system of medicine, even Siddha system of medicine, we never use the mercury with fish, through fish, or we never use as a dental amalgam or vaccine or mercury in vaporous form or gaseous form for consumption. So the claim of the toxicity, as per my knowledge is concerned, it should not be made applicable for Ayurveda and Unani metallo mineral, herbo mineral products. The first issue is that because we are not administering mercurial products both in Ayurveda and Unani through fish, or not by dental amalgam, or not by vaccine, or not by gaseous form. So we have to explain Ayush Ministry and also further government authorities in order to protect the efficacious mercurial compounds of both Ayurveda and Unani, mentioning that the method of administration is entirely different, because in Ayurveda it is very clear that sulfide form of the mercury, after various processing, pharmaceutical processing methods, made into acceptable form, after converting a safe medicament of mercury in a acceptable form, and also most of the rasaushadhis does not contain only mercury, moreover they contain most of the plant materials and other components, even animal products also. 80 to 85% plant materials are used in the rasaushadhis, where the optimum quantity of the mercury in compound form, most of the times in sulfide form, in a processed form, it has been used and found very safe and also efficacious. These medicines are found very efficacious in Ayurveda in severe untreatable conditions also. Therefore, it is our prime motto. It should be our prime motto that we have to explain the issues belongs to the toxicity, because the most of the times the pure mercury toxicity characters are mentioned to Ayurveda and Unani products. We should mention that pure mercury we are not using. Most of the time sulfide form of the mercury only we use. It is a compound form. Again, this compound mercury sulfide, it may be in mercury sulfide or it may be in cinnabar, ingul, we use by combining with various other plant medicaments, and finally the substance will be made into very safe and efficacious form, that is called rasaushadhi. In Unani it is also called kusta. And these medicines, further we studied in Ayurveda, for many of the safety studies. Just here in this slide, I'm showing that how the mercury poisoning is causing the Minamata disease, which I already mentioned, which was raised from the Japan and through fish consumption and other disease conditions like acrodynia. These diseases are never produced by the mercurial components of Ayurveda and Yunani. These are produced by some another form of mercury. It may be through fish or through gaseous form. So now we have to establish this safety study. For this purpose, these are the supporting safety studies in well-known peer-reviewed high-impact journals we have published in already, and they are available in internet all over the world. These studies of particularly this Rasindur study, we have worked in Banaras Hindu University. Over the Drosophila model also we have seen many of the mercurial compounds are studied over mice, over albino rats and Drosophila. For the first time, Drosophila model in Banaras Hindu University by Professor Lakotia from the Science Institute, he has studied found that it is very safe and efficacious. This has been, this paper has been published in high impact journal. Even Ayush Ministry also has given this information. Like this, many of the other safety studies we have conducted in Ayurveda. I know that in Yunani system also, many of the studies were conducted when I had a discussion and dialogue with pharmacopoeial members of Yunani. I came to know that most of the mercurial compounds are similar to Ayurveda, and they are also using as per their mentioning. And in Yunani pharmacopoeia also, many of the mercurial products has been mentioned, as previous speakers already mentioned, that similar to that, Ayurvedic pharmacopoeia also has been incorporated very good number of mercurial products by the name of Rasaushadis. With all this information, and another issue is that mercury is considered one of the heavy metal, as Ayurveda pharmacopoeia itself, and even in Yunani pharmacopoeia and Siddha pharmacopoeia also, since I started in pharmacopoeia commission, we made compulsory for herbal plant material also, whether plant material contains permissible limit of mercury, lead, cadmium, and arsenic. Of course, arsenic is not a heavy metal, but under the category of heavy metal, it has been included. And these metals, the permissible limit, the Ayurveda pharmacopoeia and Yunani pharmacopoeia has given very clearly for the plant materials. I am talking about the plant material which contains mercury in the form of heavy metal. The permissible limit is given. Most of the Ayurveda and Yunani industries, they are following that permissible limit. Before manufacturing Ayurveda, Yunani medicines, the industry will test the plant material. If the mercury is not crossing the permissible limit of the plant material, raw drug, then that will be used for the manufacturing. So with all this information, our drug industry is working very efficiently, moving very fast, And as for ancient Rasa Shastra, that is Indian alchemy. Indian alchemy is the specialized branch of mercurial preparations in Ayurveda. And this branch was developed very efficiently, though it was there since many thousands of years. But since 8th century, the great alchemist of Ayurveda called Nagarjuna, the efficient alchemical procedures are written since 8th century, and these all alchemical treatises are the books written from 8th century, 8th, 9th, 10th till 20th century. All those ancient books are, most of the books are translated into English. They are available with all their pharmaceutical procedures. Most of the books are considered as books of authoritative books list in Drugs and Cosmetic Act of the Ayurveda. Similarly, I know that Unani system also is having authoritative books list. In those books list also, mercurial products containing books are mentioned. So why I am telling this ancient literature is that I already showed that present day research we conducted for the safety and efficacy of the mercurial products scientifically. Similarly, we have the ancient literature, and that literature, most of the literature is available from since 8th century, and this 8th century literature is also should be considered as valuable, because the efficacy, safety, even toxicity itself, mercury toxicity itself, it was mentioned in our Ayurvedic alchemy Rasa Shastra. And we knew that the toxic characters and features, signs and symptoms, and adverse effects of all these mercurial preparations, in order to neutralize those toxic effects, the pharmaceutical procedures in Ayurveda called as sodhana, detoxifying procedures, very elaborately they have mentioned. One example I want to bring you: many of the times these mercurial materials are triturated with plant materials continuously. Because of that, there will be a magnification will be developed over the atom of the mercury, and that magnification effect will have chance to bind with plant materials, organic material, so that it becomes very safe and efficacious material. Because of that, TKDL, in which Ayurveda and Unani systems are there, in which I worked as a task force member from 2010 onwards for many years, that is Traditional Knowledge of Digital Library, working under the CSIR, Central Government Institute in New Delhi. In this institute, we worked to prove all the ancient information of mercurial products of Ayurveda and Unani, and all the information made into digitalization and made available in English. Their processing methods, as well as their therapy and efficacy, therapeutics, and those information not only in English, seven international languages means like English, French, German. Because this was made because of patenting of the turmeric by American scientists, turmeric and neem, the question raised in Indian Parliament, and the Americans told that your information is in regional language, not available in internet, so that they have patented. If it is available in international languages, like English and so-called seven other languages, then they don't have any patent right. In response to that, Indian government immediately started one program that is called TKDL, Traditional Knowledge of Digital Library, in which I was knowing director from Aligarh Muslim University was the task force member. I was the task force member from Banaras Hindu University. We made digitization of all the mercurial products in all seven languages, which give information regarding the therapeutics, efficacy, safety, and pharmaceutical procedures. So very clear-cut scientific advancement of mercurial products are mentioned in Ayurveda, because ancient literature also is very valuable, because in 8th century, when there was no computer, when there was no paper and pen, no digitalization, that time itself, over the manuscripts, the literature was written by our great ancestors of Ayurveda and Unani, and that literature that time provides the great data. So that also should be considered as a valuable data. And since those days, the people who consumed the mercurial products as medicines, they found very good results, not of the toxicity. And today we have the pharmacovigilance program, by which we are also identifying the toxicity, adverse effects, ADRs of mercurial products. We ourselves, we are noting, since every system is having potent medicines and their adverse effects, even in Western system of medicine, like allopathic medicine also, all chemotherapy procedures, radiation therapies, they have their own adverse effects. Even then they are used because of their efficacy in emergency conditions where untreatable diseases are to be cured, the patient has to be survived. Similarly, in Ayurveda and Unani system of medicine also, as per my knowledge is concerned, we use these medicines for severe conditions to protect the life, to protect the persons, to save the diseased people, to save the people. We are using in emergency condition in optimum dose. Again, in that dose, the actual mercury compound will be very less percentage. With all this information and scientific data and ancient support, ancient literature evidence, we have to request the Ayush Ministry already in Ayurveda, with the efficient coordination of Dr. Pawan Kumar Sharma, last few days we have conducted over Indian Alchemy a webinar, and very good information has been gathered. Similarly, today, since beginning, I was hearing all the classes, particularly the Abdul Wahid ji, very valuable information he has given from Hyderabad, and also Dr. Asim Ali Khan ji, because of his busy schedule, he could not join. He may join in our future programs also. And many very great experts of Unani system has given very valuable. For this, really, I appreciate Dr. Pawan Kumar Sharma ji, who took all the pain and efficiency efficiently And I am very much thankful to Dr. Pawan Kumar Sharma ji for giving me this opportunity. And also I am thankful to all great speakers of Unani system of medicine. Thank you very much. Namaskar.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Excellent. You have nicely explained the Ayurvedic aspect of our rasasadhi or mercurial products. Very nice. Very nice, sir. Now I would like to request, before Agnihotri ji, Professor Dr. Madan Thangavelu, sir, from UK. He is a genome biologist in UK and a very senior Ayurvedic scientist, having great contribution to our Ayurvedic and health sciences, not only Ayurveda. Welcome, sir. Welcome.
Pawan Kumar. Pavanji, Namaskarji. Thank you so much. Today has been, Agnihotriji, Namaskarji. Today has been another amazing journey. And the last 3 days have been very important for understanding the background and to understand the reasons for this Minamata Convention. And I think it is becoming more and more serious as we look into the implications of this convention. 134 people have signed to this. And I think we are taking action in advance. So as Pavanji says, you know, we've had 20 years to look at this from all the dimensions. And I can see that we could have done more, but everything takes its time to mature. And that over the last 3 days, what we have done is a very important benchmark on what needs to be done immediately in the medium and up to 2023. Now, when I in the chat box, I have put the last in the last few items there. It talks about the convention and the timeline, which is a very important aspect. And the timeline goes to 2032, and that is the deadline for ending primary mercury mining in known producing parties. So we have till 2032, by which the signatories would decide that we will not do any more mining. And what happens then? So we are a little bit thinking ahead and preparing for that important deadline. Now, the historic issue also has to be considered. The historic issue was about a chemical factory in Japan who were not very cautious about how they get rid of the waste material that went into the Myanmar Bay, and people started eating shellfish, which had hyper-accumulated mercurials and gave rise to complications. So there are many historical aspects, and the convention and the timeline. And with, as with all of these things, the United Nations, UNEP, are the lead players in this. And there are many other issues. The sociology of some of these institutions, United Nations institutions, all have a big role to play in how the documents evolve. And it is within this large context. So number one, that it is a pollutant. Number two, there is an agreement now between 135 member states about the future. It is important that we understand the big picture, and into that big picture is where we are putting our needs, you know, the need that is being raised by Ayurveda, Unani, Siddha, Tibetan medicine, and perhaps even homeopathy uses, but in very small amounts, some of these compounds. So this is the big picture, and within that we are putting the small details. The last 2 days we had, very wonderful presentations from many, many people. And yesterday in particular was a wonderful presentation from the industry side. We had Ranjit Puranik ji presenting his perspective on what happens when mercury supply is restricted and how the price, the cost of mercury increases and how it impacts the cost of production and what happens to the final end user, who have to bear the cost. Clearly from the presentations over the last 3 days, particularly today, all the Unani formulations that were offered to us, it is very, very exciting to see how this mercury is prepared. I see a lot of similarities between the Ayurveda Shodhana procedure and the Unani procedure, and also maybe the Siddha procedures that are there. Agnihotriji has told us about the samskars, how we purify in, purify mercury. This is another point that is very, very important, that there is a procedure called Shodhana, and there is something similar in Unani, also something similar in Siddha medicine system. We have to understand all of these things, because the one of the recommendations is that when coal, India is the world's largest, almost the world's largest consumer of coal. 70% of our electricity still comes from coal. When coal is burnt, a lot of mercury is released in the environment. And one suggestion is that this mercury can be harvested, and we don't do any primary mining, but we are doing two things. We are restricting pollution and also harvesting the mercury that comes out. So this, there is some technology that is being developed by IIT New Delhi and perhaps also in IIT Madras. They are all members of this discussion that Pavanji has started for us. Now, there are, as I said, there are many elements to this. There is environmental impact, the Minamata Convention, and the health aspects. And the clash that happens is when we go into the therapeutic use of mercury, of which India seems to be the world's largest holder of knowledge. So we are the masters, as I should say, historically and in current the current discussions. India holds mastery over this therapeutic use of mercury and the many different formulations. I think yesterday one of our speakers told very nicely how mercury is just one element, is used in so many different ways, and not only in one medical system, not only in Ayurveda, but Siddha medicine, Unani, today's description. So we have a special responsibility in that space. So yesterday, what I said was we have a big canvas, environmental issues, etc. And I think we will respect those rules, and we will find a way to accommodate our usage. I think Shastriji gave us a talk yesterday in which he said about 600 tons is what is our need, annual need, or something. There is a figure there, and that the presentation is available on the archive here. You can locate the archive. For those who were not with us yesterday, please do visit the archive to just listen to what were presented by the speakers. Now, in the concluding comments yesterday, what I made was that we will respect, I think this is an issue, mercury in the air, mercury in the water, etc. It fits in with the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals and the need to respect the environment. We will respect all that, but we also need to understand how to harvest. But most of all, we cannot compromise the strength that we have in understanding the therapeutic use of mercury. And this is very important for us. And I think this is where the Ayush community, not only the Ayurveda community, but also the other modalities, Unani and Siddha and Tibetan group, we must all come together. I think Pavanji is making this happen. In a very short space of time, he has brought all of us together. We've had deliberations from the Ayurveda group. We will now have deliberations from the Unani group today, and hopefully from the other partners also. But in all of these things, we must sharpen our thought process. So today we have had some references on use of understanding toxicity using model organisms, zebrafish, that is a small fish that is used as a model organism. Studies from IIT Mumbai, that is very exciting. I'm sorry, I keep troubling somebody who's identifying themselves as India. I don't know who this person is. So thank you, sir or madam, for sharing these references to us and also engaging with Agnihotriji about the purification process of mercury. The other point I want to say is, from that historical account, from all the Ayush modalities, we can see how old and how ancient that use is. And our knowledge there, we don't want to lose that, but we need to sharpen it. We need to identify how these mercurials work. We are clear that we are using sulfides of mercury. We are not using the soluble forms of mercury. that needs to be clarified. I think there are new techniques that are available. We have seen from Hamiduddin Ji today about the studies going on in NIUM in Bangalore on how new techniques are used. But I feel the discussion should go from the Ayush community. We must go a little more into even finer techniques that are available today. Atomic force microscopy is one technique where we can understand the atomic arrangement of each of the atoms on the surface of these small particles, these what we call basma, similar formulations in Unani Siddha. That is one area. I hope when our discussion document and our report comes together, we will be able to highlight those areas. Because the reason is very simple, that these formulations are working. The way in which they interact with the human physiology is not understood. The way in which they interact with the human microbiome is not understood. And these are there are gaps in our knowledge. So we cannot compromise all of the aspects of the dangers of mercury without understanding those mechanisms. And for that, we need to be, I think we need to be stay together as a community. And we look forward to Pavanji's ability to organize all of us, which he has shown in the last few days. We expect a little more from you, Pavanji, to bring all of us together once again in this kind of a discussion where we focus now. I'm so happy to hear from Hamiduddin Ji and also our Chaudhary Ji, the last presentation, on the beauty in which these over 1,000 years or more, these things have been used for therapeutic advantage. And I think we need to keep this debate going. And also Reddy Ji, BHU is a very important place for us. I feel we should put our heads together to see where we are going to gather our minds, whether it's BHU or Aligarh Muslim University from the leadership from NIUM in Bangalore. Somewhere we need to meet again. And Pavanji, together with Zandu, have shown us leadership. But I think we need to come back again and come back many times so that we get really the crux of the issue that is transdisciplinary, that goes across all these disciplines. And we bring the people from IIT Delhi to discuss purification process, you know, what is the status. We will bring people from IIT Mumbai to tell us what else can be done. We will get people, Ghalib Ji might still be here with us from All India Institute of Ayurveda, Sarita Vihar, to tell us what more is needed so that we can really sharpen up and deliver to Katosh Ji the key points, at least as a first draft for comments. Don't tell Katosh Ji that this is the final document. Whatever we get is a document with a request for comments from the ministry. So I feel these are key things. And only when knowledgeable people come together, like we have done today, Munshi Ji is very important for us. It is very important that we hold us together and we hold everybody together so that we can take this dialogue forward. And Pavanji, my comment here is whatever we are preparing initially must only be a request for comments. It is not a final submission from us. Request for comments with contributions from industry. So we have Zandu, we have Bhupapeshwar, we will have many other people who will join us, maybe may not be the primary makers, might be the secondary users of plasmas, etc., like Himalaya and other groups. They will all join us, or Dabar, Shastriji will guide us a little bit, but don't make it look like a final document. No, it is still a request for comments.
We'll send all speakers again for their opinion.
Exactly. So request for comments. And also it's a dialogue. It's a dialogue together with the ministry. So they are also partner. You know? So Katoshji will also be a partner at this point to refine.
That will be drafted in accordance with Sri Reddy Ji and Prajapati Ji.
Both. Exactly. Prajapati Ji, Reddy Ji.
Yes.
So we have the academia group from all the modalities. We have the industry group. I'm not aware of the Unani industry that is actually merged.
Yes, on 6th, we are organizing Unani industry by grace of Dr. Yunus Munshi Ji. Dr. Yunus Munshi Ji.
Sabash. So this is my statement at this point, but I think as we go along into the next 1 or 2 days, we get perspective from the Siddha people, and maybe Pavanji, we must also bring our friends from Sri Lanka here, you know, because they are also a bit in the controversial area, because in Germany there were some samples, Basmas, that came out of Sri Lanka that caused a lot of problem in Germany, you know. So I think we need to bring them also into our discussion. We have colleagues from Bangladesh, definitely, perhaps, who can also give us a little insight.
Would you like to introduce Sir Munshiji? Munshiji, so, Dr. Munshiji.
I feel we
Yes.
We are going for the webinar on 6th for the industrial people. Then we have the Unani fraternity in Sri Lanka, in Bangladesh, in Pakistan. We can collaborate with them also, and they can, so that it can become an international force. Countries only, or we can get on board Iranian.
Absolutely.
We'll see wherever we can go, up whatever lengths we can go, we are ready to go up to that, and definitely incorporate all the stakeholders from India and from abroad, so that it becomes a force, so that we can influence the authorities, global authorities, that they may come to some conclusion which will ultimately give relief to our industrial sector.
Munshiji and Pavanji, with your permission, I want to make a particular note to thank Kwaziji, because his insight into the, because we've been asking in our previous discussions about those old textbooks, and Kwaziji gave us a very, very thorough description of all the details. So thanks, Kwaziji. I don't know if you are still here with us. I also want to thank particularly Hamiduddin Ji here, because he is taking this ancient science in that modern direction, you know, where we need to go and where we need to use new techniques. XDR, of course, is good, but I think we need to go towards the slightly more atomic force microscopy techniques. And Hamiduddin Ji is in Bangalore, Indian Institute of Sciences in Bangalore. And I think it is much easier when you are in the same city to initiate the dialogue. Yeah. So we look to you, Hamiduddin Ji, for enabling that dialogue into that special area of finest analysis, atomic level analysis of not only Unani formulations, but also the Siddha and the Ayurveda formulations, so that we can take our heritage of use of these herbal minerals and mercurial herbal minerals to a new level of understanding, you know. And we look forward to NIUM in Bangalore. And also our colleagues, Rediji is there in BHU. And these are centers of scholarship. And I hope we can come together in that final document. We'll have a 10-year plan for where we need to go, or a 5-year plan for review or something like that. So Pavanjit, thank you so much for giving me this chance just to elaborate a little bit on what we are and where we should be.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much. You have missed us like anything every time. We are grateful to you.
I think Rediji wants to add something. Rediji, Namaskar Ji.
Namaskar. Regarding the international collaboration in Ayurveda part, I have already had a discussion with Dr. Pawan Kumar Sharma Ji, and we have in Sri Lanka very good Ayurveda faculty. And those doctors already trained in BHU and Jamnagar, and the university is already working. Ayurveda faculty are very well established, clinics also there. Similarly, in Nepal also we are having Ayurveda colleges and Ayurveda faculty, and Singapore and this Bangladesh also. Okay. I visited personally with Ministry of Ayurveda program as a leader of the team. And in Bangladesh, we have both Unani as well as Ayurveda colleges. And they are very eager to join with us. And I already requested Dr. Pawan Kumar Sharma Ji, the main countries where really Ayurveda courses are running, like Sri Lanka, Nepal, Singapore, and Bangladesh will be joining. Apart from this, there are experts of Ayurveda all over the world. Round about 50 countries including European countries, the doctors are working. Some of the doctors are using Mercurial products also. They belong to Mercurial Indian Alchemy System. And at the same time, I also want to inform the all the experts that in Banaras Hindu University, already we have conducted transmission electron microscope, that is TEM, scanning electron microscope studies, that is SEM, and X-ray diffraction. X-ray diffraction will give the molecular study, and also ICPMS, inductive coupled plasma mass spectroscopy study for these mercurial products. The molecular studies of the mercurial products have been very well established. Further, we are the Banaras Hindu University Rasayana Department very much ready for all its collaboration. And the Pawan Kumar Sharmaji very well know about the Department of Rasayana and Jamnagar Rasayana Department. These departments are always ready to collaborate and facilitate all the study to protect the ancient heritage of Rasayana. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Reddy ji.
Collaborating.
Now, for a vote of thanks and concluding remarks, I would like to request Professor V.K. Agnihotri ji for vote of thanks and concluding remarks, sir. Professor, formerly professor, he is very great dignity in Uttarakhand from Haridwar. Professor V.K. Agnihotri.
Thank you, sir. I was listening a lot. Right from all 3 days, including today. First of all, our pranam to all of you, our adab, our salam to all our Yunani counterparts. Definitely, they poured all knowledge, all deepest knowledge, since they were belonging to the academy, they were belonging to the research field, they were belonging to the administration, and they were really, really the physicians. So all aspects were covered by all these Professor Kauji Saab and Yunus Saab, everybody. And what we feel that we are two brothers, Ayurvedic persons or Yunani persons, Siddha persons, and we have got two sister pathies, like Yunani pathy or Ayurvedic pathy. So that there is nothing to our problem. Just I limit myself that they have contributed a lot, and we, it was a very eye-opener for us all. And whatever the academic and deep scientific evaluation can be done, that has made by our very beloved Madan sir. So he didn't leave anything for us to comment in that way. But what for I am scared. I feel that would we be compelled to go back to the caste Aushadhi era? Simply, we will be left to use only the caste Aushadhis, which were given by our Nighantu and Acharya Charak with the help of the Charak Sangeetas. If the ore and the minerals will be just restricted on the grounds of the its toxicity prepared by Ayurvedic system of medicine or Yunani or Siddha, it means we were making fool of our whole of the humanity for lost hundreds of years. This is, if WHO or 135 nations authorities are thinking to ban mercury simply because of its toxicity and they are well-wisher of humanity, so we are also the well-wisher of the humanity. We are making all efforts, even being a physician or our Ayurvedic persons. So this is not fair. If it will be done, it means they can snatch our Sonogari. They can snatch our Nausadhan and everything. Then we will be forced to limit ourselves only with the caste Aushadhi. So these three days webinar, the concept as Dr. Pawan Sharma is a great bridge, and he is bridging all the things, all the possibilities of each and every pathy. He is a great bridge. So our theme of this webinar is to collect mandate regarding the permission for continuation of the use of the murgi and its preparations, so that as we had been, otherwise we will be handicapped. Without para and gandhak, we will not be having any kajali, and most of the chronic diseases which are to be treated with the such preparations, apart from the local preparations. So this decision was a must, and the resolution in a form of the suggestions be put forward by Dr. Pawan Sharma and his whole team to the authorities concerned, so that they would be in position to see the manpower, the academicians' power, the brain power behind the again permission for making the mercury available to us all, and we will be in position to see all the so-called update technologies and the equipments, instruments for the assessment of their toxicity or purity, and then we will use. So there will not be any such type of curtained area or the hidden fact. We are using, we had been using, and we would like to use it, but let us made sound such authorities who are simply on the grounds of the environment, on the grounds of the toxicity, or this, that they are making or snatching our 50% of the Ayurveda as far as the treatment is concerned. So I think this is a high time that we should raise our voice with the all scientific grounds. Thank you so much.
I wish just a moment. I wish since in all the major committees of the Unani Medicine, we have Padma Shri M.A. Wahid Sahab. He's always in the Ayush committees, almost all the major committees he's. Yeah. So we can incorporate him also, how we can get help from him. I request Dr. Pawan Sahab.
Definitely.
He can pursue to M.A. Wahid Sahab, so that it can be of some
help. Last, I would like to request Professor Bahid sir to comment on today's webinar.
Wonderful.
Thank you. Would like, he is the chief guest, chief guest. Welcome, sir. I was unable to welcome you on that time. I'm sorry for that. I'm welcoming you again. Khushamadid sir, welcome. Kindly guide us how today's session was. Please guide us. Muhammad Abdul Bahid sir, kindly unmute yourself and guide, sir. Munshi ji, please moderate.
Sir, aap unmute kar lijiye, Wahid sahab. Hello. Just a minute, I'll call him. Just a minute.
Tab tak main dhanyawad dena chahta hu Jayesh Thakkar ji ko, jo mere saath hamesha jude rehte hain, aur आज डॉक्टर परीक्षित देवनाथ ने, यूँ समझ लीजिए कि मेरा रोल अदा किया, मैं नहीं था यहाँ, और उसके बाद भी परीक्षित और जयेश जी ने मिलके ये पूरी वेबिनार बड़े अच्छे ढंग से एक स्मूथली गई, तो ये एहसास होने लगा है मदन सर कि हम लोगों के जाने के बाद भी ये ज्ञान गंगा चलती रहेगी, ये ज्ञान गंगा कभी नहीं रुकेगी, कोई भी पैथी हो, हमारी हेल्थ सिस्टम्स, हमारी ट्रेडिशनल मेडिसिन्स हमेशा चलती रहेंगी, और ऐसी एक चेतना का प्रवाह हमेशा चलता रहेगा, ऐसा मेरा मानना है। आज मेरा मन गदगद हो गया सर, मैं यहाँ के बड़ा बाजार में फंसा हुआ था सर, वो बड़ा बाजार में दो आदमी पीछे से धक्का दे रहे थे, एक आदमी आगे से, तो वो उसमें मैं गाड़ी भी नहीं पकड़ पा रहा था, पैदल चलता हुआ जाने कहां से कहां तक आया, तब गाड़ी पकड़ पाया।
I have called Dr. Wahid Sahab and he is unmuting himself. तो हम उनके एक्सपर्ट कमेंट्स चाहते हैं फॉर गोइंग अहेड, बिकॉज़ ही इज इन द डिफरेंट कमिटीज ऑफ द मिनिस्टर ऑफ आयुष, ही कैन गाइड अस इन अ बेटर वे। हेलो, अब वहीद साहब आप अनम्यूट कर लीजिए प्लीज, इफ यू आर ऑन द लाइन। मेरी अभी फोन पे बात हो गई तो उन्होंने कहा कि आई एम ऑन लाइन।
पवन जी, टिल वाहिद जी कम्स, हमारी तरफ से एक आई हैव अ सजेशन कि अगले 5 साल में अगर हम पूरा देश में, नमस्कार जी,
जी वाहिद जी नमस्कार जी, वहीद साहब हमारे पास आ गए हैं, सो सर आप अनम्यूट कर लीजिए अपने आप को। हेलो फिर कॉल करना पड़ेगा आई थिंक। सर आप अनम्यूट कर लीजिए अपने आप को, अनम्यूट कर लीजिए प्लीज। डॉक्टर साहब आप अनम्यूट कर लीजिए अपने आप को। हेलो हेलो
सर, मतलब अपना सेंटेंस पूरा कर लीजिए। आपने बोल रहे थे अगले 5 साल के लिए।
डॉक्टर साहब आप वीडियो आप हेलो तब
भाई साहब काइंडली अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ सर।
आप अनम्यूट कर लीजिए अपने आपको, अनम्यूट कर लीजिए। आप बोलिए आपकी आपकी आ रही थी अभी। आप अनम्यूट कर लीजिए अपने आपको, आप बोलिए।
We waiting for Wahid ji.
What's up, Karan?
Pawan ji, can we unmute? No.
Kindly unmute yourself, sir.
What's up? आप अनम्यूट कर लीजिए प्लीज। देयर आर सम टेक्निकल इशू आई थिंक। सर आप अनम्यूट कर लीजिए अपना माइक, अनम्यूट कर लीजिए। यस अभी आप अनम्यूट हैं आप तो प्लीज।
हेलो हेलो
सर सर हेलो हाँ वहीद साहब आप अनम्यूट हैं आप बोल सकते हैं प्लीज। आप बोल सकते हैं।
एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस यू आर ऑडिबल।
ओके सो थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर
सर। पहले पहले मैं बताऊं सर, पहले मैं बताऊं
ए पर्टिकुलर ड्रग व्हिच इज वेरी हैज एन ए वेरी सिग्निफिकेंट in the usage in the entire Ayush system of medicine in general and Unani medicine in particular. So it has, as I told you, it has in a wide application of topical application, oral application, and as is fumigation also. Many drugs, as I told you, many drugs, many combination, this particular drug along with the many herbal complication put together will convert into very potent formulation, which are used in a varied skin disease. As I told you, there are diseases with a lot to the pruritus, chronic ulcers, healing of the chronic ulcers, TDs, especially septic ulcers in those days, very successfully treated. And in addition to that, many surgical problems which can be solved without surgical intervention with the application of this particular drug along with in a combination with the herbal drug. So by and large, this is one of the best formulation along with this particular drug can also be used as an adjuvant therapy in many other diseases. And very specific preparations, Kushta preparations of Unani medicine has a wide application that converts this drug to the nanotechnology. The concept of the nanotechnology was given way back in 1000 years United System of Medicine, and converting these drugs and these formulations into nanotechnology in the Kusta farm. And Kusta farm is improve their potency and improve the efficacy, and this FDA office is already established. So by and large, I'm a strong advocate of integrated approach in the not only the management of various diseases, but use of a particular this formulation, this single drug in a various formulation, and creating the evidence of safety and efficacy data, and at the shelf life, something very important, because these drugs, especially when we convert into the this kind of the formulation, then it the shelf life is too high. But still, there's a scientific relevance is a need of the hour for regulatory purposes to fulfill the regulatory issues. I think that is something very important. We need to work on it, and we request the government of India, and we request the WHO World Health Organization to consider the limited usage of these drugs, not in the wide spectrum usage, but in a certain formulation where there are potent formulation converted into a very specific formulation, along with some formulation when it changes its chemical structure and increases the potency of the drug, and added to it, the efficacy increases and the safety is big concern which is established. So with these few words, I'm strongly recommend grant of permission, not only by the Indian government, the government of AYUSH will take this message forward to the government of India in order to take the approval of the Ministry of Health, Government of India, and finally, through the Government of India, it will go to the World Health Organization, so that World Health Organization's slogan should consider the age-old system with safety and efficacy of this drug, not only to establish and continue, but have some funding in a certain institution in order to create awareness, usage, ensure the usage, and confirm the safety and efficacy. As I was mentioning in my talk, that as far as the safety is concerned, efficacy is already established, and which is already documented in the classics of United System of Medicine, based on the experience of our ancestor physicians. That, based on that, the system enjoys a partnership both from public and the government, and that is their system survived for 2,000 of years just based on its efficacy and the so-called the potent system of medicine. So these are all formulations are very potent, and at the same time, as the researchers and teachers of the United System of Medicine and the stalwarts of the other OU systems of medicine and industry, my industry colleagues can definitely concentrate on taking forward this study to confirm the efficacy and safety studies. Let's throw the scientific, must we give the scientific relevance and create the evidence-based data, probably get it published, and probably we can reach to the masses and throw the publication into scientific journal to the scientific personnel across the world and across the system, and to the regulatory agencies like World Health Organization, the US FDA, and Indian authorities. And not only that, the best thing is they confirm the safety, preclinical safety, both in the animals and at cellular level, cellular studies, and the efficacy studies. Efficacy studies in terms, as we say, there's a great demonstration of the wounding of the cells, and the great demonstration of the resolving of the extragranulation tissues. These are all considered to be surgical problems, and we do not have any surgical intervention. Without that, we have a topical application of this drug, which this particular drug, which can definitely help in resolving these masses where there's a development of extragranulation tissue. So with these words, I take forward my message with all my colleagues, not only the United System of Medicine, but the colleagues of the all AYUSH systems of medicine together to the AYUSH to put forward this to the Union Ministry to permit us and take granted a permission from World Health Organization to broader use and broader use along with the certain combinations which are already documented with the Yunani classics of medicine and the Ayurveda classics of the Yunani of the medicine, so that the preparation methods, standardization of those methods is also in the need of the hours. So standardization of the method, creating the safety efficacy data, the need of the hour probably will take it forward to fulfill the need of the regulatory agencies in order to get permission and to sustain our claim to broader use of this drug. Could it be a single form or could it be a formulation along with the other herbal drugs, which ensures the safety and efficacy of the drug? Thank you very much.
Sir, we wish to take you on board in this initiative. Whatever we take, let it be Ayurveda industry and academia, let it be Yunani industry and academia. If you permit us, we will take you on board. And I request Dr. Pawan sir to keep Wahid in the core committee, whatsoever they decide. The core committee member Ame Wahid will be there, and with permission from Dr. Wahid sir. From Dr. Wahid sir.
I'm always with you.
Thank you. Sure. We will be grateful, sir.
I'm always with you. Yes, I'm in a forefront leader. I'll be in a forefront to take your message forward to the not only to the Indian jurisdiction,
so
but to the international jurisdiction. Yes.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot.
Good night. But please don't forget to join tomorrow, sir. Tomorrow is very unique competition, Dhanvantari Stuti competition, which will be participated by 25 competitors. All videos have come to us, so there will not be any technical glitch. This I can assure you. Please join us tomorrow at 7 p.m. Thank you all. Good night,
thank
sir.
You
good night,
sir. All. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody.
And very happy to have many people on the board, many experts on the board. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Yunusji.
Thank you, Yunusji. Namaskar.
Thank you, Namaskar.
Namaskar. Reddy ji, Namaskar.
Namaskar to everybody. And thank you.